Thunderstorm conditions killed about 5% of mature dairy cows in the state. The group does not yet know how many heifers and calves have been lost. Executive Director Darren Turley said as farmers continue to assess the damage, the number of losses is expected to rise. Turley said in the statement, "The immediate challenge is how to handle these sudden, massive losses of animals. The ordinary methods for disposal cannot handle the volume of deaths we are seeing from this storm." Turley also said blizzard conditions prevented employees from accessing the farms to milk cows, which typically needs to happen twice a day. Turley said, when a dairy cow goes that long without being milked, her milk supply starts to dry up. That means the dairy cows in this region will give less milk for months to come. Less milk going to market will be felt by consumers as well as by dairy farmers. Hundreds of loads of milk waiting to be processed went to waste during the blizzard. CNN reported storm system Goliath barreled through Missouri, Texas, Oklahoma, and Georgia earlier this week, causing at least 49 deaths. The upper Midwest and Northeast were also hit with several inches of snow and freezing rain.
For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports Missouri Governor Jay Nixon on Saturday toured communities in his state ravaged by flooding that killed at least 31 people in several states and forced the evacuation of thousands in the Mississippi and Ohio River regions as the danger of rising waters shifted to Arkansas and beyond. Nixon visited Eureka and Cape Girardeau in eastern Missouri, where floodwaters caused widespread damage, and announced that he was requesting the federal government declare an emergency to help with the massive cleanup and recovery now underway. The National Weather Service reported Mississippi floodwaters in Illinois and Missouri began cresting and receding on Saturday after thousands of people had to be evacuated from their homes earlier in the week when the floods destroyed hundreds of structures. 12 counties have been declared disaster areas in Illinois, where Governor Bruce Rauner on Saturday toured several communities hard hit by flooding. On Friday, he ordered Illinois National Guard troops into flooded areas to mitigate damage and help with evacuation. The floods claimed the lives of at least 31 people in Illinois, Missouri, Oklahoma, and Arkansas, many of whom drove into flooded areas after days of downpour. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The Onion looks back at this week in history. On July 21st, 2007, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows, the final installment in the widely popular Harry Potter series, was released, as excited fans all over the world eagerly flipped to the book's final pages to find out if Harry and Lord Voldemort finally
Author J.K. Rowling had already succeeded in creating one of the most popular literary franchises of all time. And of course, much of that success was owed to the expertly crafted sexual tension that steadily built up between the series' protagonist, schoolboy wizard Harry Potter, and the Dark Lord Voldemort. Everyone in the country wanted to know whether or not they would f***, and if they did f***, how many times would they f***, and who would be f***ing who.
And that was what happened this week in history. In the words of Mother Teresa, if there is one lesson to learn from the past, it's that no matter what you do, there will always be a bunch more crippled dying kids.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here if you want. So we'll give you our toll-free numbers and our Skype username. Big news was spread all over social media last night and today about the armed takeover of a government building in Oregon. Definitely want to talk about that here tonight. It's actually the son of Cliven Bundy, who listeners may recall the whole Bundy Ranch controversy from, what, a couple years ago now? I think at this point, with you tonight in the studio, it's Ian
and Daryl.
We'll give you the latest, give you the details on what's happening in Oregon. Maybe you're out that way and you want to comment. You're welcome to join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. We also have Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. So we're going to get into that here in a few moments. But first, let's go to Dennis. He's on the line in New Hampshire via Skype. Hello, Dennis.
Greetings, gentlemen.
Hey there.
So there's been the social media issue that sort of blew up yesterday concerning toplessness and the whole issue of sexism really erupting in the New Hampshire legislature.
Yeah, you had some New Hampshire legislators. For those who weren't tuned in last night, we spent pretty much the whole show on the controversy between a few legislators, all of whom are purportedly pro-liberty state reps. A couple of these guys were being very, very rude and talking down to Amanda Bolden, who's a free stater and also a state representative. She was defending topless freedom, and they have sponsored a bill that would make it a misdemeanor penalty of up to 1 year in prison or 1 year in jail for women being topless in New Hampshire. That's what the controversy has stemmed from.
So there's an activism opportunity in the New Hampshire legislature, particularly in the House of Representatives. There's an opportunity, and it comes up just for a couple of months out of the year, and I have an idea, or rather, I guess, a request, but it's kind of sexist. And I think that this is one of these things where I have this really sexist idea, and I thought Free Talk Live is a good place to get that kind of idea out there.
Okay.
So you're familiar with the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance and the gold standard and the fact
we may be familiar, but our listeners are not. But go ahead, could summarize.
The legislature is starting up this coming week, and they will be voting every Wednesday, most Wednesdays, for now, for the next probably 4 or 5 months. And, of course, one of the things that the Liberty Alliance does, we read and review and rate the bills that that these folks are going to be voting on.
You rate them based on whether or not they're a pro-liberty piece of legislation or they would damage freedom or they're sort of middle of the ground, basically. In fact, Daryl is one of these bill reviewers, and he told me he's reviewed over 70 bills now at this point.
Yes.
Daryl, which is like almost a tenth of the entire amount of them. But yeah, it's a great, the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance does amazing work, and there's no other organization out there like it that I've ever heard of anywhere.
And Daryl, by the way, to thank you and the cadre of bill reviewers, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of bills have been reviewed now, and that's just awesome work, and people are doing that right now as we speak. So the group gets together and puts together this, what we call gold standard. This is our piece of paper that's always trademarked gold sheet of paper that lists out this particular bill. Here's how we want you to vote, and here's the libertarian talking points of why we want you to vote this way. And it's always an enormous amount of work going through all the bills and really making those points and so forth. But at the end of the day, on Wednesday morning, as the representatives are filing into their seats and getting their coffees and preparing to vote, and they're used to just coming out of their caucuses, whether they're on the Democratic caucus or the Republican caucus, where they've been given a sheet of paper that basically tells them, here's the party line and here's how we want you to vote.
Right. So just to be clear, they get a sheet of paper from their party, which gives them the party recommendations. Then as they're walking in to go and vote, they also receive a sheet from the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance, this gold standard you're talking about, which gives them the pro-liberty voting recommendations. That doesn't happen anywhere else in any of the other 49 states, does it?
And here's where I've got like a sexist request. If there are any preferably attractive but definitely female people who are in New Hampshire and are available, say 8 o'clock in the morning on Wednesdays, I'm telling you, if someone's going to hand you a piece of paper with some idealisms or some talking points, really now, as people who are involved in media communications and sales, you do understand that these ideas are more attractive if an attractive person is handing you these ideas. And let's be honest, in general, people in general find ladies more attractive than us guys.
Yeah. I think that's true. I think if you asked women that they would also agree that that women are more attractive. I'm sure there are exceptions to that. Are you suggesting, Dennis Goddard, that there be topless women handing out the gold standard at the state house?
He never said topless.
I know. I know you hadn't gotten that far. I'm guessing. You didn't tell me in advance, so I'm just taking a shot here. What are you getting
at? No, I actually hadn't even thought of that, but I knew I could count on you, Ian. I could count on you. No, but seriously, there are a group that, you know, and that's something that I've done from time to time, years where I had the ability. Now I've got a conference call at that time. I can't make it. But I know that they need volunteers. And honestly, this is something where if you're female, it's real easy to, I mean, really, it's for anyone to do, really. But I would just implore anyone who like really looks good and doesn't mind just smiling at people and handing them a piece of paper. That's a thing that people can do.
Okay, so you're just asking for attractive females to join the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance and then go on Wednesdays to help hand out 400-some sheets to the state representatives as they're coming into the building.
Yes, and I should hasten to add that I'm acting as a lone wolf, that I'm in no way doing this at the request of anyone, probably at the shock and disgust of people from the Liberty Alliance.
Okay, but you aren't suggesting that they be topless, because that didn't seem like something you would suggest that could be seen.
That sounds more like something you would suggest,
right,
Ian.
Yeah. No, I don't think that would be a good idea. It probably wouldn't give you the right publicity, but it would certainly get you
right.
Attention.
I'm just wishing that there was the letters in gold. I can't see where you could put the two dots inside of something circular in a letter like O's or E's. Maybe the O and the D. Something could be done.
So, I think it's good. I think more people do need to get involved in the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance. And, you know, even if you don't have the time to do the bill review stuff, which is a hugely important task, you can always donate money to the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance, because I think they're probably arguably doing the most important political work in New Hampshire. I mean, would you say that's a fair assessment, Dennis?
Oh, of course. Yeah. Possibly in the world. What do you mean, just New Hampshire?
Well, yeah. I mean, there's nothing like it in the world either. That's certainly true. NHLiberty.org is their website. So that's a way for people to get involved in what's happening here if they're not in New Hampshire. Like, obviously, if you're in New Hampshire, please get involved. But if you're outside of New Hampshire and you're listening to our show and saying to yourself, well, I really love what you guys are doing, but, you know, I've got this career, I've got this family, I've got this whatever that's keeping me where I am, but you still want to help out, you could sign up as a bill reviewer for the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance, start reviewing these, this legislation. You don't need to live in New Hampshire to participate in that.
Indeed. But you do have to live in New Hampshire to hand pieces of paper to incoming legislators and just smile and say,
if somebody
nice
wanted to drive up from Massachusetts, I don't think
they
you
could.
Would turn them away.
Yeah, that's true. Hey, thanks, Dennis, for your call here tonight. So, Dennis, putting out the official invitation to attractive women to come to New Hampshire and get active. I am fully in favor of this idea.
I'm in favor of it. I'm just surprised that the suggestion came from Dennis Goddard.
Why? Why not? I mean, who doesn't want more attractive libertarian females in New Hampshire, even though he has a girlfriend? Who doesn't want that to be the case? I mean, the fact is the Liberty Movement is sadly solidly a majority male.
Yes.
And you know, I don't know if that's – it'd be interesting to see the breakdown of the Republicans and the Democrats and the Greens to see, you know, what percentages are male versus female. I mean, if I had to guess, I'd say there are more females involved in the Green Party than the Libertarian Party.
Probably.
I mean, with the limited experience, I did know some greenies when I was active down in Florida with the libertarians there. I knew some greenies, and most of the greens that I knew were female, but that certainly by no means was an accurate cross-section of the Green Party.
Right.
So toll-free number tonight here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've also got Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. There's a armed takeover of a government building, a federal building, not clear on that. We'll get those details here, in Oregon.
It's a building on a national park.
Yeah, involving the Bundys.
Are you thinking about your Medicare benefits right now? You know, Original Medicare may not cover all of your needs, and the deadline to choose your plan is rapidly approaching. Plus, whatever Medicare plan you choose is locked in for a full year. So the wrong choice could cost you thousands of dollars in out-of-pocket costs. At Health Markets, we can help you find a plan to minimize those costs with one free phone call. You could spend hours doing all the research yourself, or our licensed agents can do it for you for free. Call Health Markets now for free help.
800-978-4818. 800-978-4818. 800-978-4818. Again, that's 800-978-4818.
Health Markets Insurance Agency is a DBA of InSphere Insurance Solutions. Licensed in all 50 states and D.C. Service and product availability varies by state. Agents may be compensated based on your enrollment.
This is a healthcare alert from the Pain Relief Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee, back, shoulder, or ankle pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You don't have to suffer any longer. You can immediately qualify for a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost to you by calling our 24/7 pain relief hotline at 866-389-0620. Delivery is free and all paperwork is handled for you. If you are on Medicare and have knee, back, shoulder, or ankle pain, don't wait. You can qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost by calling our 24/7 pain hotline now at 866-389-0620. Our representatives are standing by 24/7 to take your call and rush you your pain-relieving brace at little or no cost to you. Shipping is free and all paperwork is handled for you. Just call 866-389-0620. That's 866-389-0620. Again, 866-389-0620.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and it's the live Sunday edition of the program. You are invited to join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Daryl.
Don't forget, you can join us on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. And there's a movement in healthcare today full of people ready to stand up and take charge of their healthcare. Folks like you who are tired of paying too much for healthcare and getting too little. People who are standing up for their values and letting their conscience make decisions based on timeless principles. It's a movement that's sweeping the nation, and you should be part of it. Liberty HealthShare is leading the movement of people who are looking for an alternative to traditional health insurance. Liberty HealthShare is a healthcare sharing organization of people who are sharing the cost of healthcare in an easy and efficient way. Choose your own doctor, your own hospital, and live out your values in healthcare. Join the movement and change healthcare for good. Go to join LHS, as in Liberty HealthShare, joinlhs.com, or call them toll free at 800-722-8041. That's 1-800-722-8041. 8041 joinlhs.com. So, big news right now, developing story is coming out of Oregon,
where Politico and several other news sources are reporting on a protest over the impending prison sentence of two Oregon ranchers who are facing 5 years each, I believe, time in prison for arson, allegedly. That has now escalated into a militia-led armed occupation of a federal wildlife refuge, one that the leader vowed late Saturday could last, quote, for years, unquote. The occupation, which is being led by Ammon Bundy, the son of a Nevada rancher involved in previous clashes with the government, and two of his brothers, came on behalf of the ranchers and not at their behest. He said, quote, this facility has been the tool to do all the tyranny that has been placed upon the Hammonds, Ammon Bundy told the Oregonian in an interview published Saturday night from the Malheur National Wildlife Refuge. He says, quote, we're planning on staying here for years, absolutely, which is a pretty big claim to say they're going to occupy a government building for years. He said, it's not a decision we've made at the last minute. He called the refuge destructive to the people of the country or the county and to the people of the area. On Sunday, Harney County Sheriff David Ward said the militants were not there to support the ranchers, but to help spark efforts to, quote, overthrow the county and federal government in hopes to spark a movement across the United States, unquote. He urged people to stay away, and Harney County closed its courthouse for Monday. Reports suggested the occupation began following a protest with approximately 300 marchers, both militia and local residents in Burns, about 30 miles northwest of the refuge and about 280 miles away from Portland. The protesters marched against the prosecution of two Harney County ranchers set to report to prison tomorrow for lighting fires in 2001 and 2006 that they said reduced the growth of invasive plants and protected their land from wildfire. Dwight Hammond Jr. and Stephen Hammond, ages 73 and 46 respectively, were convicted 3 years ago, with the father serving 3 months and the son a year. Since that time, however, the judge or a judge ruled their sentences were too short, meaning that they were sentenced to time for setting these fires. And then later, after serving some time in prison, the judge comes back and says, yeah, you got to go back to prison. Oh, yeah, we know we already let you out. You already spent, you know, whatever the sentences were here, 3 months and a year, respectively. But now you got to go back for 4 more years. Dwight Hammond says he and his son are going to be reporting to prison in California on Monday without incident. So the Hammonds themselves aren't involved in this actual takeover of the federal wildlife reserve, but their supporters are. In a video posted to his Facebook page on December 31st, Bundy said, quote, this is not a time to stand down. It's a time to stand up and come to Harney County. We need your help, and we're asking for it. No matter what your leader says, no matter, I don't know who the leader is, no matter what they're saying, you need to draw your own conclusions. You need to get to Burns on the 2nd or before. We need your help. Bundy's father, Cliven, who led a month-long confrontation with the federal government on his Nevada ranch in 2014, said Saturday he didn't necessarily agree with his son's approach. He said to Oregon Public Broadcasting, quote, that's not exactly what I thought should happen, but I didn't know what to do. You know, if the Hammonds wouldn't stand, if the sheriff didn't stand, then, you know, the people had to do something, and I guess this is what they did decide to do. I wasn't in on that, unquote. Beth Ann Steele, spokeswoman for the FBI, told the Associated Press they were aware of the incident and had no further comment. According to the Oregonian, the number of armed militia members occupying the compound remains unclear, with estimates ranging from 15 to 150. So, yeah, I would say
that's quite a range.
That's pretty unclear. Maureen Peltier said, as one of the sympathizers, writing on Facebook, saying, quote, if you believe in their cause, only numbers can help them. They are asking you all to join, armed or unarmed, but with no hostile intent, peacefully. They are not terrorists. They will not harm anyone. Daryl, taking all that information in, your thoughts as a liberty-minded person who obviously, you know, shares concerns perhaps about the federal government and land grabs and things like that. What do you think about this?
You know, I don't know. Hopefully it winds up ending similarly to how the Bundy Ranch thing did, whenever that happened last year,
you
2 years ago, whatever.
Where the federal government had this kind of a standoff and then ultimately backed down?
Right, where no shots were fired and no one got injured.
But
hopefully it does not wind up happening like what happened to Randy Weaver's family, to where his wife got shot in the head while standing in the kitchen holding her baby.
Now, wait, there's differences, though, between all three of those situations, right? So with the Bundy Ranch, you had a group of supporters coming out to the ranch area, right, where they were protesting, and I forget what the exact location of their protest was and why it mattered. Were they trying to arrest the Bundys at that time? I'm forgetting the details as to.
I don't remember if they were trying to arrest the Bundys or just remove all of his cattle from the federal land that his cattle were on.
So, but my point was, I guess, that the protesters.
Yeah, there's certainly different scenarios.
Right. The protesters in the Bundy case were outside. They were, you know, not inside some sort of building occupied by the federal government. In the case of this case, they are actually inside a federal building. And that's going to be, I think, a little bit more of an in your face move.
Certainly.
It's going to be something the feds are going to feel more compelled to, let's say, rebuff with violence.
Yes.
You know, looking at the Occupy movements, because this has some similarities. I was involved with Occupy here in Keene, New Hampshire. I didn't go down to New York City for it or anything like that, but there was a smaller movement here in Keene. And so I was paying pretty close attention to Occupy, and we talked about it quite a bit here on Free Talk Live. Of course, Occupy was involved, for the most part, in occupying park areas, but there were some exceptions, like in, I think it was Oakland, where the occupiers actually went into City Hall and trashed the place, which I thought was an interesting move. So that was really the only example that I can remember from Occupy where they actually went inside government buildings. And, you know, even in the cases where they didn't go inside government buildings, the cops came in a lot of those Occupies and cracked down in those parks, attacking physically the occupiers and arresting, making multiple arrests. So the federal government hasn't made a move in this particular case yet. This is a developing situation. We've got an interview with Amon Bundy here that CNN conducted. Might give us a little more insight into what he's thinking as one of the leaders of this particular protest. Please call in, share your thoughts.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for under $30,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet under $30,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait.
Call 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here. Your thoughts, welcome, especially, well, you can bring up anything you want, but especially welcome on the armed takeover of a government building in Oregon, where folks, and they don't know how many, maybe as few as 15, maybe as many as 150, they broke off from a peaceful protest supporting a couple of guys who are going to be turning themselves into prison in California on Monday for setting some fires on federal lands.
Hold on. So these guys are turning themselves in.
That's correct.
But people decided we're going to take over this building anyway?
Yes.
I thought, and maybe I somehow misheard, I thought the people were taking over the building to prevent the guys from being either just rearrested or turned in.
No, they're going to those guys are going to prison. They've been sentenced an additional amount of time for setting those fires back in the early portion of this century, and one of them's in his 70s, by the way. So they're literally putting an old man in a prison cell for another few years, and so these guys are just mad. I mean, they support the Hammonds. The Hammonds are the gentlemen who are turning themselves in. They support them, and they want to let the federal government know they are mad about this. So this is
their
way.
Then this makes even less sense than I thought it did.
What do you mean by that?
Well, if they were, taking over this building to prevent the men from being rearrested, that would almost make sense to me. But the men are planning to turn themselves in tomorrow, apparently.
That's correct.
So now people are just taking over a building for absolutely no reason than to be like, we're mad and we're going to stay here to show you we're mad.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's their reason. I mean, the occupiers didn't need to have people that were going to prison to get them mad enough to go and occupy Zuccotti Park in New York. They were mad about a variety of things the government has done. And these
with Occupy were mad about things the government didn't do. They wanted a $20 an hour minimum wage. They wanted more bailouts for they wanted the people to be bailed out instead of banks. That they had a bunch of reasons.
No.
I don't think they were necessarily valid reasons or good reasons.
Well, it's not fair to say they, Daryl. You're grouping all the occupiers in together there unfairly.
When a group calls themselves Occupy Wall Street and says, here's our mission, or here's what we're calling for, and they say $20 an hour minimum wage,
doesn't mean
free education, then that means at least a majority.
Yeah.
Although I was told that Occupy worked on quote-unquote consensus, which means supermajority. A supermajority of people that were involved in Occupy wanted free stuff from the government.
I'm going to give you, there's no doubt the occupiers, a lot of them were, people who wanted more control over the government and wanted the government to do things for them. I'll give that to you.
But there were a lot of people at Occupy who knew that the government, something was wrong, and they just weren't sure what to really do about it. And they wanted to come express their frustrations with a lot of the things the government was doing. There were a number of libertarians at Occupy. A number of our friends were there in Zuccotti Park, including Free Talk Live co-hosts like Michelle Seven and Derek J. Freeman. So there were a lot of people at involved in Occupy across the country. The Occupy in New Hampshire was strongly libertarian, and they would not have come up with the same list of demands. In fact, in Occupy New Hampshire, there was actually a split between the commie occupiers and the libertarian.
That incorporated.
That's right.
The group that...
The commies incorporated.
The commies that were saying corporations are bad,
right.
Incorporated.
Yeah. It was so funny. So I don't think it's fair, Daryl, to say all occupiers were doing this, which is sort of the impression you gave when you initially said that, because not all occupiers agreed. I think the one thing that they did agree on was things are wrong.
The only thing you can say
country.
All people blah, blah, blah is all people breathe air.
Right. So I just wanted to clarify that, that not all occupiers were communists.
The vast majority, minus a handful of people, yeah, I realize that, you know, the whole collectivist term mm-hmm. thing really annoys you.
Yeah.
But it's really hard to, you know, when people form a group
right.
and issue a statement on behalf of the group, it's hard to say anything other than this group supports.
Sure, but, you know, again, that statement only came from the Zuccotti Park Occupy, which in no way represented the other Occupies. There were several Occupies all around the country, and they were all different. You know, the occupiers in Oakland were much more radical, anti-propertarian kind of, or anti-property people with no real respect whatsoever for the idea of private property or anything like that. They were much more destructive of property than some of the other occupiers who would be more likely to like clean up after themselves, for instance. And again, not all occupiers are good at cleaning up after themselves either. So again, we're talking about a group of individuals. If there's one thing that I think they did agree on was that things were messed up in the U.S., and I think that's something they have in common with the Tea Party as well, where, you know, a lot of the people in the Tea Party also felt like something was wrong with the government. Now, some of the people in the Tea Party thought the government needs to have a bigger military and, you know, crack down on the borders, while other Tea Partiers were more libertarian, like a Ron Paul, for instance, people who actually want less government in our lives. So again, you can't really say the Tea Party did this. You can't really say Occupy did that. I think we do need to keep it down to the individual level if we can. But back to the story here about Ayman Bundy and these, what maybe as many as 150 protesters, maybe as few as 15, we don't really know, that have taken over a federal building in Oregon. And they are saying they're going to stay there for years. This guy says he's prepared to stay for years, which seems a little unbelievable.
Well, being prepared to and able to are two completely different things.
Yeah, I don't, you know, I don't believe that they're going to be able to, stay here for years, because at some point the federal government's going to come in.
I think he might be able to stay there for the rest of his life.
You mean until the federal government extinguishes his life?
Yes.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Let's go to Will. He's on the line in Tennessee via Skype. Will Coley from MuslimsForLiberty.org. Hey, Will.
Hey, guys. How you doing tonight?
What's on your mind?
Well, I was watching this whole thing with the Bundy thing kind of unfolding, and I'm seeing echoes of Waco, you know, headed our way across across the Midwest. It looks like, you know, this looks like it could be another opportunity for the government to show us just how big and bad and soulless that they are.
So you're expecting an armed crackdown on these armed protesters that could result in a bloodbath?
Well, I mean, it kind of looks like what the protesters themselves, some of them have expressed.
Tell me more about that. I haven't actually seen any of these interviews that you're talking about. I've only heard an interview with Ayman Bundy, who's sort of the head of it. What have you heard?
Well, the one of them that I saw probably about an hour ago was, "I didn't come here to shoot. I came here to die."
Whoa. You know,
yeah. So, I mean, if that's the expression that's coming from some of these people, and, you know, they may not be, you know, the inner circle, so to speak, of the people that have, you know, decided to put this together. But when you have people that have that mindset, then you have the opportunity for a like a Boston Massacre type situation, you know, where, you know, they're agging or you know,
he wants suicide by cop. I mean, he's
that's kind of what it sounds like, and or martyrdom, so to speak.
Has anybody gone Sheriff Mack and said, put the women and children up front?
Are there women and children involved in this?
I don't know, but there were at the Bundy thing, and Richard Mack wanted to put them up front.
So they get shot first was the idea?
Yes.
And well, this I haven't Richard heard Mack that there are any women and children. None of the reports that I've heard are that there are any women and children. I think it's mostly just male militia members and then the three members of the family that are reported to be there.
So, I mean, are you seeing video, these protesters that are talking, is the media on the scene interviewing people? I don't have cable, so I don't have any way of actually seeing the video footage from this.
Well, I'm getting it the same way most other people are. The stuff's coming through social media. There's interviews. They're being uploaded online, and then they're being, you know, shared through social media. So, you know, that's what I'm seeing. One thing I do find kind of interesting is that they've kind of given a moniker to this group, the left has. They call them Y'all Qaeda. And I think it's kind of funny that
Y'all Qaeda.
Yeah, that the left is allowed to employ these anti-Muslim stereotypes and this anti-Muslim language as long as they're attacking.
Well, hold
right.
that thought if you've got more you want to share. This is Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now, 1-800-719-9349. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now, 1-800-719-9349. That's 1-800-719-9349. 1-800-719-9349.
Did you know that home break-ins increase more than 100% during the holidays? It takes just 10 seconds for an intruder to kick in your door. But police response to a home alarm system is more than 20 minutes. And intruders are in and out of your home in 5 minutes. Thieves know that you're not home and have presence inside just waiting to be taken. And if you are home, how safe will you feel with an intruder lurking inside with your family? That's why police across the country are recommending you use Door Armor. Proven to withstand the force of a battering ram, Door Armor keeps intruders out. It's easy to install and barely visible, and your Door Armor is guaranteed for life. Go to invasionstopper.com for a very special buy one, get one at half off deal. These savings are for a limited time and only available to GCN listeners. Protect your valuables and loved ones this holiday season. Go to invasionstopper.com now. That's invasionstopper.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on Saturday night. From there, I went on joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. When you amp Free Talk Live, you get perks like access to the AMP only Facebook group and AMP podcast. Visit amp.freetalklive.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm. If you want to play online poker with Bitcoin, you need a site that's trustworthy and technically sound. The site managers of swcpoker.eu have proven their commitment to bringing you great gameplay from a site you can trust, swcpoker.eu. They have lots of new games too, including Chinese poker, and their Krill leaderboard is open right now. It's a beautiful site, easy to use with lots of players. Go on over to swcpoker.eu now and have some fun with your Bitcoin. swcpoker.eu.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. There are armed protesters right now in a U.S. federal government building in Oregon, the Malheur Wildlife Refuge. We're going to continue here. You're welcome to share your thoughts on the occupation, the armed occupation, which is one of the things that sets them apart from the Occupy movement. Plus, their politics are probably a little different. The toll-free number here, if you want to share your thoughts, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Daryl.
And don't forget, you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. And if you like what we're doing on Free Talk Live, then please get your shopping done with us. Go to shop.freetalklive.com and enter Amazon through the links you'll find there. There's Amazon UK, Canada, and US. You just click into the right Amazon for you, and Free Talk Live will get a cut of the sale. It's that simple. You get the stuff you're looking for, the same great Amazon prices, free Super Saver shipping, Amazon Prime, everything you're used to with Amazon, you're just entering through our affiliate link, so Free Talk Live gets a portion of the profits. Once again, start your shopping at shop.freetalklive.com. We do have Will Coley on the line with us from Tennessee. And Will, you're a member of the group Muslims for Liberty, muslims4liberty.org. You were commenting on this occupation. You're saying you think this is going to turn into another Waco.
Well, that's the way it looks to me. I mean, that's my automatic assumption whenever the state is involved, is that it will end in violence, because, you know, that's usually the first and last solution of the state is violence. So if you have, you know, those who are in this case, quote unquote, violently resisting the violence of the state, then the state's only really recourse in these types of situations is usually violence.
These people are saying they're
completely prepared to stay there for, as Daryl put it, the rest of their lives, possibly years. And that was the way it was with the Branch Davidians. They were prepared to be there as long as it took for the government to sit there and wait. And, you know, the government has shown, their track record shows that if forced to sit and wait, they'll simply burn you out.
I want to disagree with one assertion that this would end up like Waco. And I would say it would end up more like Ruby Ridge than Waco, because Waco had a lot more people, possibly, although they are saying
maybe
that there might be 150 there.
How many people were in the Davidian compound?
There were 87 that wound up dying. Okay. There were a few that escaped, mostly children.
So there could be similar numbers here.
Possibly, but the situation was completely different, where the Waco thing, there was a religious freedom aspect to it. Mm-hmm. And there's not in this situation at all.
Well, also in
so
Waco,
the circumstances here seem a lot more similar to something close to the Ruby Ridge.
Well, Ruby Ridge was also someone's home, as was Waco. So at least at Waco, you could say they were prepared to stay for years because they probably had food stored up in their facility. Whereas here, they just went in this weekend, and whatever food they brought in, they've got. But they sure as hell aren't prepared to stay for years. They don't have enough. They couldn't possibly have brought in enough food unless they brought in pallets of it, which just seems pretty unlikely.
MREs and...
Yeah, but I mean, how much could they possibly have packed into this place? I mean,
hell if I know. I don't know how big the place is.
I don't know either.
But when I hear building in a national park, I'm thinking of a cabin. I'm not thinking of like some giant office.
Yeah, I'm not sure what the size of the building is. Will, you've seen some of the footage. Have you gotten a scope for the size of the actual building?
No, not really. So it just looks like a from what I'm seeing, it looks kind of like a welcome center.
Yeah, I mean, I can't.
Okay, so welcome center. I've seen welcome centers again that were basically the size of cabins, and I've seen welcome centers
sprawling complex of offices.
Yeah, some giant complex that was probably 15,000-20,000 square feet.
And this is a wildlife refuge. It's nowhere near a big city, so odds are good it's on the smaller side rather than the larger one. But either way, you know, they broke away from a larger protest of about 300 people, then went several miles away to this wildlife refuge and presumably broke into this building. The building was empty at the time that they went into it. So it was the, you know, whatever staff might work there during the week. They broke in after they'd closed for the weekend, so there was no one there, apparently not even, you know, janitorial staff. Building was empty when they went in, so whatever they brought in with them is all they've got. Unlike the Branch Davidians, who likely were stockpiling, you know, meals ready to eat and other food and water and things like that for quite a long time. I think that the Branch Davidians were much better dug in, if you will. Plus, they were defending their own home. They had guns and things like that that they, you know, and they, you know, had trained in that area. This is completely new territory for these people. And they, I don't think there's any way they can stay there for years because they'd likely have to get food to come in from the outside. And one of the first things the federal government's going to do is cut off anyone else's ability to come in from the outside. One of the things that sets this apart from the previous Bundy situation was with the Bundy ranch, that was outdoors. People could kind of come in from anywhere. Yeah, they did try to set up a perimeter or whatever, but you know, it was a little. It's a little harder to control an outdoor area in Nevada than an indoor building. So I think they're going to have a much tougher time here getting supplies and backup from the outside. As soon as the feds arrive and surround this place, and I don't know if they have yet or not. That's going to basically cut off any more chance that these guys are going to get any food. So it's going to be a very interesting standoff. Will, any other comments you want to share? Go ahead.
No, not really. I just I wonder how many because you've heard they've quote unquote put out the call, and you have, you know, these different organizations that are devoted to, you know, answering what they are calling this call that they're putting out for quote unquote patriots to come and, you know, be a part of this thing. How many armed individuals from around the U.S. are actually going to answer this call and go? And if that, could we have a possibility for a situation where you can have two standoffs, where you have one standoff of the people who are coming from the outside who want to bring assistance to these people, and a standoff with the people on the inside, where you can have like the ATF and the feds having basically a quote unquote, like a war, so to speak, that they're fighting on two fronts?
Good questions. Thanks for the call tonight, Will. Appreciate hearing from you. That's Will Coley from the Muslims for Liberty. Muslims, the number 4, liberty.org is his website.
So I'm trying to find out more information on this building, and I actually went to the website
for the Wildlife
Refuge, the Malheur National Wildlife Refuge, and right on the front page, they say Malheur Refuge is closed, and then it says, why is the refuge closed? They are reporting, this is the feds. The Fish and Wildlife Service is aware that an unknown number of armed individuals have broken into and occupied the Malheur National Wildlife Refuge facility near Burns, Oregon. While the situation is ongoing, the main concern is employee safety, and we can confirm that no federal staff were in the building at the time of the initial incident. Mm-hmm. We will continue to monitor the situation for additional developments.
So, and no indication of the building size. You don't see any photos on the site.
I've not yet found that information. I'm going to dig around on their site just a little bit more.
Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. So, I mean, I immediately questioned the claim that they're going to be staying there for years. I mean, the federal government is not going to allow that to happen. They didn't allow the Branch Davidians to stay in for very long before they
burned, more than a couple of months.
Burned them out and burned the place down. They, of course, you know, for our younger listeners who don't remember, Waco was the mid-1990s, if I'm recalling correctly, during the Clinton administration. David Koresh was the leader of a compound of religious folk who, I guess he believed he was the second coming of Jesus or something like that.
Yes.
He was wanted for court, as I understand it, and had failed to appear in court. They came at him not when he was out on his regular walks that he took, apparently, around the neighborhood, but when he was inside the compound, surrounded the place. I don't remember how long that standoff lasted. I was a young teenager at the time.
It was a couple of weeks, possibly up to a couple of months.
Yeah, I don't remember all the details on that, but ultimately it ended when the feds came in with guns a-blazing and a tank and literally crushed a wall of the place down, allegedly shot a firebomb of some sort into the building. There's some controversy over how the fire actually started. Some believe it was the Branch Davidians who set it themselves. Others believe the federal government set that fire, and ultimately people, including children, perished in the blazes. So, you know, what sort of version of that will we see here in Oregon? I don't know. But, you know, if you remember the story from here in New Hampshire from about a decade ago, there were a couple who holed up in their house in Plainfield, New Hampshire, I believe it was, Ed and Elaine Brown, who the IRS wanted for failure to pay taxes. And they did not want to go to prison for that. So they decided they were going to defend their home with guns. And they had guns, and they had friends come out with guns to ostensibly help them out. Ultimately, that ended without a gun, without shots being fired, because federal agents had befriended them. Undercover federal agents had acted as though they were on the side of Ed and Elaine Brown. They were going to have a pizza party, and then during the pizza party, they arrested Ed and Elaine and took them without incident. So are there undercover agents in this protest?
Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof money to the people where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom in the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com. Are your kids spending too much time online? Are they gaming instead of doing homework? Are they on Facebook instead of sleeping? Turn their internet access on or off when you want for free at webcurfew.com. 100% web-based interface means nothing to download, install, or configure. Webcurfew is free and controls any device using your home network without slowing down your internet. Block all adult web content with the click of a button. Don't let the internet raise your kids. Take back control of how and when your home internet is used for free. Visit webcurfew.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading on Thursday, gold is $1 lower at $1,063 per ounce. Silver is even at $13.93 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $423. Our offices are closed this week for year-end processes and to enjoy the holidays with family and friends, but you can still shop our online store at rrbi.co for some of the best deals you'll find on silver and gold. rrbi.co.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate us 5 stars, then share the link on your social media and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 2 is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene and the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, January 3rd, 2016. Silver is trading at $13.87 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,061 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $433. Anti-war.com reports months of bloody infighting over the leadership of the Taliban movement has reportedly ended, with a deputy from the splinter faction headed by Mullah Rasool announcing that the talks had ended in a ceasefire and an agreement to exchange prisoners. Questions remain, however, as the splinter delegation was only able to meet with Habatullah Akhtun, a deputy of leader Mullah Mansour, and was told Mansour is refusing to meet with anyone over security issues. On December 2nd, Mullah Mansour was reportedly seriously wounded in a gunfight among Taliban commanders in Quetta, Pakistan. The Taliban denied that he was wounded in the incident, calling it propaganda, but he has not been seen in public since. This is only adding to the speculation that he's in bad shape, with the concerns about the Taliban not being forthcoming about leadership changes underscored by the revelation in mid-2015 of founder Mullah Omar's death, leading to Mansour's election. Omar was revealed to have been dead for years.
Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system and to fully capitalize on that decision in their fundraising efforts. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com.
UPI reports winter storms that ripped through the central and southern United States at the end of 2015 dealt a blow to the dairy industry in Texas. The Texas Association of Dairymen said in a statement on Saturday that winter storm conditions killed about 5% of mature dairy cows in the state. The group does not yet know how many heifers and calves have been lost. Executive Director Darren Turley said as farmers continue to assess the damage, the number of losses is expected to rise. Turley said in the statement, "The immediate challenge is how to handle these sudden, massive losses of animals. The ordinary methods for disposal cannot handle the volume of deaths we are seeing from this storm." Turley also said blizzard conditions prevented employees from accessing the farms to milk cows, which typically needs to happen twice a day. Turley said when a dairy cow goes that long without being milked, her milk supply starts to dry up. That means the dairy cows in this region will give less milk for months to come. Less milk going to market will be felt by consumers as well as by dairy farmers. Hundreds of loads of milk waiting to be processed went to waste during the blizzard. CNN reported storm system Goliath barreled through Missouri, Texas, Oklahoma, and Georgia earlier this week, causing at least 49 deaths. The upper Midwest and Northeast were also hit with several inches of snow and freezing rain.
For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports Missouri Governor Jay Nixon on Saturday toured communities in his state ravaged by flooding that killed at least 31 people in several states and forced the evacuation of thousands in the Mississippi and Ohio River regions as the danger of rising waters shifted to Arkansas and beyond. Nixon visited Eureka and Cape Girardeau in eastern Missouri, where floodwaters caused widespread damage, and announced that he was requesting the federal government declare an emergency to help with the massive cleanup and recovery now underway. The National Weather Service reported Mississippi floodwaters in Illinois and Missouri began cresting and receding on Saturday after thousands of people had to be evacuated from their homes earlier in the week when the floods destroyed hundreds of structures. 12 counties have been declared disaster areas in Illinois, where Governor Bruce Rauner on Saturday toured several communities hard hit by flooding. On Friday, he ordered Illinois National Guard troops into flooded areas to mitigate damage and help with evacuation. The floods claimed the lives of at least 31 people in Illinois, Missouri, Oklahoma, and Arkansas, many of whom drove into flooded areas after days of downpour. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Following the announcement of First Communion, The Holy Spookerist, the first hardcore pornographic movie to be filmed in Vatican City since 1982's classic adult feature Pope Fister's Four, Onion Reporter spoke to Herschel Savage, director of the film.
It's a huge honor for me and everyone else involved with this film. This is where they shot Pope Fister's Four. I mean, that movie's a masterpiece. Well, when we wrote up the script, we sent it over to the Vatican to get the Pope's approval and see if he had any notes, but he loved it just the way it was.
The highly anticipated pornographic film, which stars Ron Jeremy as the horny sea himself, Pope Benedict XVI, will reportedly contain graphic sex scenes filmed in the Sistine Chapel, St. Peter Square, and the Popemobile, among various other notable sites within the Vatican.
Well, actually, I'm just watching a cut of this amazing scene we shot last night where Pope Benedict is gangbanging a bunch of nuns in his bed. And it was great because the Pope let us use his bedroom. Tomorrow, we're shooting the scene where two nuns fuck each other on St. Peter's tomb using strap-on crucifixes. I think people are really going to like this movie.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the radio waves. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. There's an armed group of protesters occupying a building in Oregon right now at the Malheur Federal Wildlife Reserve. They are protesting the extended sentences of a couple of ranchers who set some fires on federal lands, which were supposed to be controlled burns. And those controlled burns apparently went a little out of control. Either way, I don't know if even if they were controlled, they would be legal. I suspect they wouldn't be setting fire to federal lands like that. And anyway, those guys were sent, they're the Hammonds, the father and son team. They were sentenced to some amount of jail time for that in the previous decade. Sorry, Daryl, I forgot to flip your mic on there.
The father got 3 months, the son got 1 year.
And so now, I guess what happened more recently was the federal government, in the form of one of their judges, came and said, yeah, you guys did spend time for that. You committed your sentences and you got out of jail and you thought you were done. Well, we say you're not done now. You get to go back to prison now for 5 full years in total. So you've got another 4 or so years that you need to go back in. So please go report to your nearest federal prison and we will go ahead and take you in on Monday. So now these guys are expected to report to prison on Monday, and I think rightfully so. People are angry about this. I mean, that is a crappy deal. I mean, it's bad enough to have to go to prison when no one was actually harmed in any kind of conflict,
right?
Or in whatever the supposed crime was. That's bad enough. But to then add insult to injury and to, you know, spend time in prison, get out, think you're all done, and then have some judge issue an order saying, yeah, we missentenced you. You're going to have to go in for another 4 years now. Okay, bye now. You know, one of them 74 years old. So, I mean, just absolutely horrible.
73 and 46.
Yes, it's horrible what they're doing to these guys. So I understand the frustrations. And, of course, there's more to these protests than just protesting what's happening to the Hammonds. It's the bubbling over of frustrations that many people have with the federal government, with the federal government's control over people's lives. And so they've decided to take over this building, and we're still not sure. You've been trying to figure out the size of the actual welcome center or whatever it is that they've,
right,
they've taken over at
and
this wildlife refuge.
And I can't find that information, and I'm not sure which building exactly they took over. But if they took over the headquarters, that's right next to a lake,
okay,
which means that they would probably be able to fish for a while to get food if they didn't bring enough with them.
Because they are saying they're planning on staying for years if necessary.
Yes.
In this circumstance. So we're going to learn more, of course, over time as this develops. This literally just started last night. I believe the takeover happened sometime during our show last night, so we didn't get word of it until today or until late last night is when I started to see it pop up on social media. A lot of people are paying attention to this. And there's a couple of other interesting details here in case you're just tuning in. They did break into this building while it was empty. So
yes.
That has been – and also another thing, they don't know how many there are. There could be as few as 15 protesters. There could be as many as 150. And they want more people to show up, which brings me back to the discussion we were having in the very end of the last hour. And that is that in the case of the Branch Davidians, they had themselves a compound. They were locked down. It was only the members of that church that were in there.
Yes.
They weren't letting people in. with the case here in New Hampshire about a decade ago of the folks who were wanted by the feds for not paying income tax, they did want people to come help them. They were allowing people in. I went there. Actually, Mark and I, Mark was my co-host at the time. We went there physically. They had a barbecue once where some of the Genesis Communications Network hosts were actually present at this barbecue. Ted Anderson, the president of GCN, was there barbecuing at this compound.
That would be more than just host, because you and Mark would be host.
Right.
The owner of the company is more than just a host.
Right. The owner of the syndicate, the radio syndicate that we're on, Ted, was actually there in person, you know, cooking on the barbecue. He was the one who kind of funded the party that happened. And so people came in from all over to support Ed and Elaine Brown.
And something else with the Branch Davidians, the feds were actually preventing some people from leaving that wanted to leave.
Wow, I didn't realize that.
Yes.
So this is, you know, a different situation from the Branch Davidians, but it may end in a similar bloodbath. Although in the case of the Browns here in New Hampshire, that ended without violence because the feds had managed to infiltrate into the group of supporters. And by the time they took down Ed and Elaine,
I would say it ended without physical harm.
Okay, right. Nobody got shot. Nobody got permanently injured in the takedown. But they waited until basically the supporters, for the most part, had left, because you can only spend so much time on this. Like, unless you're independently wealthy and you've got nothing but money and time to devote to something like this, these guys are saying they're going to be there for years. I highly question that 150 people are going to be there for years. I question whether even 15 people are going to be there for years.
I think a handful of them will probably be there for the rest of their life.
Right, which you could mean was another day if the feds came in and cracked down. Now, they're not likely
going to
make it.
It's going to be, you know, a few days, possibly a couple of weeks.
It could be longer than that. With the Browns, it was, if I recall correctly, several months before the feds actually made their move. Now, they were on the premises. They were nearby. They had
Well, the Browns were also in their house. They weren't on a national wildlife reserve.
On federal property. I see where you're coming from there. But, you know, to some extent,
the response as far as the timetable is going to be a little bit different.
I think you're probably right about that. But on the other hand, the federal government probably doesn't want the negative Waco-style publicity. So they may try to avoid shooting it out with these people. And one of the ways to avoid that is to bring in undercover agents. So,
or what you do is, and I swear I am not trying to give the feds advice, but it's going to sound like it. These people, probably because they're on a wildlife reserve, might go hunting for some food at some point. When one of them shoots at a bird, you say, "We heard gunshots. They fired."
Yeah.
And then we're defending ourselves, would be the response from the feds, because shots were fired.
That's how this could go bad, right? If even if it's, whether it's people actually out hunting or whether it's an undercover agent who goes in and fires a shot, either way, the excuse of gunfire could be used to slaughter these people. But
even though it's, they're shooting at a bird to try to get a meal,
or maybe it's an undercover agent who's firing just so they can keep, so they have an excuse
certainly
to shoot. Either way, that would be how this could go really, really bad. But it could go less violently if they infiltrate enough undercover agents in here. Because, again, these people have requested for more people to show up.
Yeah.
So they have indicated that they are going to allow people to come in. And if they're going to allow people to come in, there's not going to be any kind of vetting process. I mean, if somebody shows up with a camouflage hat, a camouflage jacket with an American flag behind them, because apparently even though these guys are protesting the federal government, they're carrying American flags, which seems like a mixed message.
Yes.
You know, you show up with the right trappings and you show up with, you know, some sort of rifle strap to your jacket, you're going to get into this place. I mean, what are they going to ask? What series of questions are they going to ask to, you know, to vet out potential undercover agents from getting inside?
Is Obama a Muslim?
Yeah. So they're, you know, if the feds have enough undercovers that they can get in there, they can take, you know, positions nearby the actual protesters, and then at some point take them down. They could have a coordinated takedown and end this without any bloodshed. But from what we heard earlier, I think it was Will who pointed this out, one of our callers, that you got people who basically are suicidal. There was apparently an interview with somebody who intends to die in this circumstance, that he's not there to walk out of this alive. And if you've got more than one person like that, then you've got a really unpredictable situation. If these people are going in, now I don't know how many of them are unarmed. If there are 150 of them there, or 15, we don't know. And of the amount that are there, are 100% of them armed? Are 50% of them armed? Are 10% of them armed? So we don't know how many people are inside this building. We don't know how many of them have guns. The feds certainly don't know that. But as soon as they get an undercover agent in there, they are going to they're going to know that stuff. So it should be very interesting to see how this develops. Our toll-free number here, if you want to share your thoughts, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
Now, one interesting question with this refuge being closed and they're asking for people to show up, how will they get there?
It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveitpurse.com.
For over 5 years, you've been hearing about the Berkey guy, so you may know a few things about him. For example, you are well aware of the superior quality and effectiveness of Berkey water filters and accessories. But did you know the Berkeys have had independent lab tests done to prove just how effective they are? It's true, and he can email you the test results. Just visit GoBerkey.com. You may also know that the Berkey guy has helped tens of thousands of people get better prepared. Now here's something you may not know. GoBerkey.com has amazing specials and deals all the time on a wide variety of survival and preparedness products. Most ready to ship same day. Visit the Berkey guy at GoBerkey.com and be sure to click the red Products on Sale Now button. You can always call toll-free 877-886-3653. Again, that's 877-886-3653. GoBerkey.com, home of the Berkey guy.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. I know this sounds unbelievable, but at my house, we saved as much as 45% off of a new item on Amazon. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Cryptocurrency and peer-to-peer tech developments happen fast. Stay in the loop with the Daily Decrypt, a new video channel and podcast that will keep you on top of the latest innovations in crypto finance, security, networking, transportation, and gadgetry like drones and 3D printers. Subscribe to the Daily Decrypt on YouTube and SoundCloud and be an early adopter of the future. The Daily Decrypt.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us right here, toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Daryl.
We want to invite you to our website. Just go to freetalklive.com and enjoy all the features you'll find there completely free. One of the things we offer you is a way to save big time over at Amazon. How about 20%? How about saving 20% on everything you buy from Amazon from now on? You can do that, at least as long as SaveItPurse.com keeps working. SaveATPurse.com, and it's working very well so far. They've saved their customers over $500,000 in their first year of operation.
Woohoo!
I personally have saved over $700 at this point. I bought like 30-something times through SaveItPurse.com in the last year, and it has worked amazingly well. The catch is you've got to have Bitcoin in order to save this tremendous amount of money. In fact, you can save more than 20%. You choose your discount. Now, the higher the choice you make, the longer it might take to fulfill the order that you're going to make. But if it's an item you want, but you're not in a hurry to get, set it higher and see if you can get the discount. I've gotten a discount as much as 45% off in the past, and I frequently request 20 to 30% off, and it's no problem whatsoever to save that much on pretty much anything at Amazon. So go and get started at saveitpurse.com, saveatpurse.com. We are talking about the occupation of the armed occupation of a building, some sort of, we don't know the size of the building yet. Well, I'm sure we're going to learn all these details in the upcoming days, or however long this goes for, until the federal government inevitably tries to use some sort of level of violence to take these people out. Will there be a bloodbath, or will they go down without any kind of blood being shed? All of that remains to be seen, but the feds are not going to stand for allowing their building to be occupied like this. Now, of course, the counterclaim is that it's not their building at all. The federal government doesn't own anything legitimately, and so it's actually the people's building.
One of the ranchers there, Ryan Bundy, who is one of the sons of Cliven Bundy,
right,
said the best possible outcome is that the ranchers that have been kicked out of the area, then they will come back and reclaim their land, and the wildlife refuge will be shut down forever, and the federal government will relinquish such control. Well,
that's a nice idea.
What we're doing is not rebellious. What we're doing is in accordance with the Constitution, which is the supreme law of the land.
What do you think about that? You know a thing or two about the Constitution.
I think that he's holding the Constitution to some reverence that it does not deserve. To quote Butler Schaefer, the Constitution is that thing that prevents the federal government from doing all the horrible stuff that it does.
Well, yeah, and that's a variant on the Lysander Spooner quote that the Constitution has either authorized the tyranny that we have or has been powerless to prevent it. Either yes. way, I don't know if you'll find any provision in the Constitution that authorizes people to violently take back land from the federal government.
Right. But this statement here sort of explains why they're waving American flags.
Because they're lovers of the Constitution.
Yeah. They love America, and America just ain't America enough for America, because America done turned into something other than America.
Well, right. And this is one of the issues with protest groups like this, is that, you know, they talk about freedom, but really they just want their own system. They want to impose their way on other people. So even if they were to be successful at taking back this land, ultimately they want to see this happen in more than this one location.
Yes.
They want to see ostensibly this kind of takeover happen of federal lands everywhere. And I don't necessarily disagree with the concept of the federal government shouldn't own any land. I don't think the federal government should exist at all. But these people believe in the federal government.
Yes.
They just want their version of the federal government to be the one that is ruling over the land, even if it's their land or it becomes the people's land or whatever. They still want a federal government. They still want a union, and they would be willing to use violence likely to keep their union together.
Now, probably.
I'm speculating there, and we'll get some actual quotes, more quotes. You just shared one of them. There's an interview with CNN that a different Bundy brother, so there's a couple of them involved in this as leaders of this protest movement. We'll play some of that audio for you here, but we're going to go to your phone calls and thoughts. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Also, Skype in at Skype username lrn.fm. Let's go to Matt. He's in Tennessee. Matt, you're on with Ian and Daryl on Free Talk Live.
Well, I love your scripted intro. I didn't think it would take you that long to get to me, but
scripted intro?
New Hampshire first, because I've been listening to your whole show tonight.
No one was reading from a script, by the way, just to clarify. Go ahead.
Okay, maybe it was a spirit. I don't know. But the, you know, the bill in New Hampshire where women want to expose their breasts. I think that Representative Laura Jones probably opposes that.
What's that have to do with anything?
Well, it has everything to do with government and the separation of powers.
You're talking about the issue we discussed last night quite a bit. It was about a bill proposed not to allow women to expose their breasts. That's already legal. It would criminalize
with up to 1 year in jail.
Yeah, and I don't know what
Laura Jones did she support that?
I don't know, but right now the sponsors of the bill are all male. So as of the moment, there could be more co-sponsors that sign on, as I understand it. But right now, all of the co-sponsors of said topless prohibition legislation are all male, sir.
But that's a state issue. That's an issue in the state of New Hampshire, and I think it's a beautiful state. And I think every state is beautiful because people are beautiful. But I will tell you one thing about the federal takeover. They're making a mistake. It's legally wrong.
What? Who's they? Who's making a mistake?
The Bundy sons.
Okay.
That are doing the Oregon thing.
What are they? What's wrong with their takeover?
Because they have legal adhesion to the federal government, to the New World Order.
Legal adhesion. What does that mean?
That means they have swapped their God-given rights that came through the Magna Carta and the rights of Englishmen, which influenced, you know, from about, you know, the 1200 AD to about 1900. You know, it's been quite a mishmash of things.
But, hold on. So do rights come from God or the Magna Carta? You said God-given rights from the Magna Carta, and that's a contradictory statement.
Well, you said it. I didn't.
He said that God-given rights through the Magna Carta. Did God need a document to portend those rights to the American people centuries later?
Well, people need to have a spirit of liberty.
I don't think
they don't really need a document, but at this point they do have documents, and they're doing a bad thing in Oregon.
So did people have rights before the Magna Carta existed?
They always have. It's just people are vanity. They're very vain.
Then why even bring up the Magna Carta if people had rights before the Magna Carta?
Well, I guess he wants to stand on some sort of authority. Matt, thanks for your call tonight. I don't really care for the answer. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Dudes all over the place. Everything from breasts to the Magna Carta. Yeah, you can bring up anything you want here on Free Talk Live, though coherence is certainly preferred. 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. More about the occupation of the federal building in Oregon coming up. Free Talk Live.
Removing bad taste and odor from your drinking water is easy. Removing the bad stuff you don't taste is what ProPure does best. Water the way nature meant it to be. Clean, crisp, and refreshing. See the complete line of ProPure countertop, inline gravity, and household water filtration products. Visit your authorized ProPure dealer or ProPureUSA.com. That's ProPureUSA.com or call 800-544-3533.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and sling bows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
The new fourth edition of Healing Our World, The Compassion of Libertarianism, will take your understanding of liberty to a deeper level and has over 1,300 updated references, new cartoons, and a foreword by Dr. Ron Paul. With discounts for multiple book purchases, the fourth edition of Healing Our World is a great gift for the liberals, pragmatists, environmentalists, and Christians in your life who think libertarianism is cold-hearted. Get yours today at healing.freetalklive.com and use promo code FTL for a $5 discount.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site; two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com; three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards managing and improving it. This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute. The most influential component of your credit score is your payment history. Almost equally as important is the amount you owe on credit accounts. Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized your credit, the number of new accounts, credit inquiries, and your various types of credit accounts. To help achieve or maintain a healthy credit score, have a system set up to assure your bills are always paid on time. Don't max out your cards. It's better to have a high credit limit with a low balance. Never close old accounts. The age of these can actually help your credit score. But don't be afraid to use your credit. You need several accounts in order to have a credit score. Just keep the corresponding payments within your means. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Daryl.
And we've got all kinds of issues we could discuss, but right now the real big news, in my opinion, is what's happening in Oregon with a group of people. We don't know how many of them there are. We don't know how well-armed they are. They have taken over a federal building in Oregon in the Malheur Federal Wildlife Reserve. They broke into the building this weekend, sometime I think Saturday, after a protest of some sort happening to support the Hammonds, which is a father and son who are going back to prison after having already gone to prison on some unauthorized burning, basically, charges.
They were charged with arson.
Yeah.
Because they started fires on their property, and then the fire went over onto federal land.
Yes, and they went and they served time on that, and then a judge later came back and said, we're going to need you to come back and serve another 4 years of time in prison. So they're going to turn themselves in on Monday, and that has sparked a very revolutionary sentiment in a lot of people who've gone and ostensibly have brought in enough supplies, they claim, to live in this building, this federal government building, for years, which, as we understand it, is some sort of a welcome center at the Malthur National Wildlife Preserve. So that's the situation as we know it. There is now a video, Daryl, you just linked me to a 14-minute long video, which we're not going to be able to play on the air, at least in its entirety, or at so far in any kind of segments. It's a man sitting in his car, some sort of SUV-looking van thing. He looks like he's got that kind of Marine look to him, and he is apparently a former Marine. Blaine Cooper is his YouTube channel, Blaine Cooper. That's already racked up over 171,000 views. He posted it on December 31st, and apparently he is planning, he's saying goodbye to his family. And we've watched a few months ago off the air, we did watch the first couple minutes. It's a very pausey kind of video. He's pausing a lot.
Very jolted.
Yeah, he's very emotional. He's very emotional. He's, you know, very careful with what he's saying here. He's speaking to his family, his kids. It sounds like he's planning to not come back from this, is what this sounds like.
Yes.
And there was another quote from someone else purportedly who's on the scene, who was interviewed earlier. We talked with Will Coley from Muslims for Liberty about it, who made it sound like he was planning on dying in this particular this takeover of this federal building. So you may have some suicidal people that are armed in this building who are prepared to go through a death by cop. We'll continue to get more information as the show goes on, as the situation develops. I do have an interview, though, that we can play from CNN that they conducted with Ayman Bundy, who's the son of Cliven Bundy. Listeners may recall the Bundy Ranch situation from 2014. Well, some of the Bundys are involved here as leaders in this federal government building takeover at the Malthur National Wildlife Refuge. Let's get into the clip here from CNN.com. It was an interview conducted earlier this morning that they're going to play for you. And here we go from CNN's website.
I'm going to take you to Oregon now, where armed protesters have taken over the headquarters of the Malthur National Wildlife Refuge. The property is managed by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. No government employees were on the land at the time because the refuge was closed for the holidays. Well, the armed occupation grew out of a protest earlier in the day in the nearby town of Burns. That rally was to show support for two local ranchers, Dwight and Stephen Hammond. They were convicted of arson and sentenced to 5 years in prison. They're expected to turn themselves in Monday morning. Now, one of the men behind the occupation of the wildlife refuge is the son of Nevada rancher Cliven Bundy. You remember him? He was at the center of a tent standoff last year with the Bureau of Land Management over grazing fees for his cattle. Ayman Bundy says he hopes other like-minded people will join the armed protest at the wildlife refuge.
Now, one of the things before we get into the actual interview here, one of the things you had questioned, Daryl, was we still don't know the layout of this property. Is this wildlife refuge welcome center right on the main drag? Can people easily show up at this place, or is there a big cordoned zone from the federal government that's going to prohibit people from getting
well,
to this
place? Well, the feds are saying that the wildlife refuge is closed. Generally, right. When you close a place, you block off all of the roads.
Well, sometimes. Sometimes not. I mean, we don't know what the situation looks like.
We're also not sure which building on the property they're in.
Right.
There could be more than one building. We don't know if they're necessarily in the Welcome Center. We don't know if they're in the field headquarters.
Well, the notice that it's closed could simply be something they've put. You read it from their website earlier.
Yes.
That just could simply be informing people, hey, you can't come here. That doesn't mean they've put up barricades on the roads, but maybe they have.
They may have.
So
who knows?
Can people actually reach these protesters to provide them with backup at this point? Certainly if
if there's not roads, you know, it's certainly a lot of nothing. So they could hike through the wilderness to get there.
So let's continue here.
For those that understand what is going on and those who want to and feel a need to stand, we're asking them to come. We have a facility that we can house them in. We have plenty of work to do to start to unwind all of these unconstitutional land transactions.
There's no work that you're going to do to unwind any of this. I don't know what he's talking about. It's not like they can do anything to unwind the federal government's control over all this land. I mean, I understand they're making a stand, and that I get that. I get where they're coming from with the frustrations. I share frustrations with even the existence of the federal government. I'm sure these guys still want a federal government, but they just want to be in control of it. But I can understand where they're coming from. But the idea that there's going to be work done here to unwind anything, no. This is just going to come down to violence, likely. I mean, they're making a stand, and the federal government isn't going to they're not going to let them just go quietly, I don't
think. But, Ian, if we write these words in just to write fashion and right order and then send it to the correct judge, then the judge will realize the entire sham that happened in 1908 when the Mount Huron National Wildlife Refuge was created as a thing.
And the judge will order all of the federal agents to stand down and leave these people alone.
We just have to write the words in the right order.
Yeah. I guess we'll see what happens.
And controls to... And we have plenty of work to do. Need you to come and be unified with us so we can be protected and be together, and we're calling people to come. Absolutely.
Eamon Bundy is on the phone with us now to explain what he hopes to accomplish. Thanks for making time. I know it's quite early there in Oregon. I want to start first with the question of the purpose of taking over this building. What are you hoping to accomplish engage the federal government to get the land returned from the refuge to the people who live there, a commutation of the sentences? What is the goal specifically?
Good question.
Well, one is to get people aware of what's happening, that from the very beginning of the existence of this refuge, it has been destructive to the people of the county and to the people of the area. This refuge alone is 187,000 acres. And in order to make that 187,000 acres, it took 100 ranchers' homes and livelihoods and everything in order to make it. And so we have a very good example of how a government is taking and destroying livelihoods to make themselves a little park.
But Mr. Bundy, let me ask you, what specifically then, using that as the context of this standoff, what do you want from the government? Do you want the sentences for the Hammonds to be reduced, or do you want them commuted? What ends this?
Well, this isn't a standoff, by the way. We're not walking around with a bunch of guns and so forth. Excuse me?
It's not a standoff? Well, it's going to be when the federal government shows up and goes ahead and surrounds this place.
This little park.
I want to find out more. We'll get to the rest of the interview here. There's about another minute and a half. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. If you want to share your thoughts, 855-450-3733.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536. Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
College roommates continue their bonding process until real friends are made, and a teacher hopes they never Google him. It's time for the weekly video feature that's heartier and more comforting than a heaping bowl of mom's butternut squash soup. This is the Onion Week in Review. Longtime James F. Blaine Elementary School teacher Suzanne Pomponio told reporters today that she could not believe how much fatter her second graders are getting. Pomponio estimates that each and every one of her kids must be 8 to 10 pounds heavier than anyone in her 2011 class, adding, quote, "and those kids were pretty fat too."
Honestly, I didn't think it was possible that this year's kids could be fatter than last year's, but they are. I mean, short kids are fat, tall kids are fat, and there's a smell. I don't really know how to describe it.
Local dad Michael Corain navigated several discount travel websites today with a precision reminiscent of 18th century Viennese prodigy Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart composing a symphony.
This is the Onion News Network.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Back now, more Free Talk Live. You may join us. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Daryl.
We are playing an interview conducted by CNN this morning, early this morning. It was 7:40 Eastern time, so in the Pacific time zone, 4:40 in the morning, when they were interviewing Ayman Bundy, who's one of the leaders of the occupation, an armed occupation of a federal building on a 187,000-acre large piece of property in Oregon, the Malheur Federal Wildlife Preserve or Wildlife Refuge. They are protesting generally just sort of the overreach of the federal government and confiscating people's lands and, you know, controlling people's lives, and more specifically protesting the Hammond father and son who are going to prison on Monday for setting fires on their lands spread to federal wildlife lands, ultimately resulting in a initial prison sentence. They were released, and then a judge coming back later and issuing an order ordering them back to prison for another 4 years. So that's some of what's going on here. The protesters are claiming they're armed up and they have enough supplies to last for years in this what was an unoccupied building because it was the weekend when they came in to take it over. Presumably, there are normally federal workers that would go to this place on Monday morning, but now now the park has officially closed, according to a notice posted on its website. Has the federal government surrounded the area yet? We don't yet know what the situation outside is. Certainly, there's news media that's on the scene. There's a story from OregonLive.com that has several photographs of the Malheur Wildlife Reserve, and it looks like basically open land. This isn't a forested kind of reserve, so there's not like a bunch of trees around. There's plenty of available places for snipers to set up and things like that or whatever. And
I was looking at a map, and there's a lot of lakes and water and probably something akin to swampland.
Yeah, there might be some different elevations involved, perhaps maybe some hills or whatever, but overall this is pretty much flat area. And I'm not seeing much in the way of construction, at least in any of these photos. There is apparently a tower in which some of these people, some of the protesters have taken over. And so there's a tower on the property, like a lookout tower, like a fire tower or something like that.
Yes.
And so there are men, presumably with guns, in that tower overlooking the property. We're still trying to learn more sort of as this continues to develop. There's snow on the ground as well. So it is it's cold, and there are as many as 150 people occupying this building and as few as 15. One of the leaders, Ammon Bundy, has conducted an interview with CNN saying he wants more people to show up, that they are dug in and they're planning on staying for years if necessary. The CNN host is asking this Ammon Bundy, what do they want? What is it that you want to see happen here? And so far hasn't really gotten a clear answer. Let's continue here with the audio of said interview from CNN.com.
Yeah, we want the government to abide by the Constitution, abide by the authorities in which the people have given it, and to play by the rules so that the people can live and prosper without fear and without being terrorized.
Well, I got to say, I mean, that wouldn't be so bad. I don't support the existence of the federal government at all, but certainly I'd much rather they actually follow the rules they're supposed to follow, where, of course, anybody who's been paying attention knows that pretty much everything the federal government does is unconstitutional.
Yes.
So, I mean, they're so far out of bounds from their constitution that the idea that a group of 150 people maximum occupying a piece of property or occupying a building on this piece of property is somehow going to wrest the federal government back within its boundaries.
Well, Ian, it only took 56 men to create the federal government.
And this is ostensibly
this
more than 50.
This is three times as many. Almost.
So you don't think this is going to work then, right, Daryl?
I don't.
Yeah, I don't either. The federal government is so violent. They're so dangerous. They, these are the same. This is the same federal government who goes around the world bombing innocent people. If you think that they're going to just go ahead and get rid of their power and start being Mr. Nicey Nice because a few people decided to occupy a building on a wildlife refuge, I think you've got another thing coming. And many of them know this, which is why they are talking like they're not going to come back, some of them.
So somebody that's in the Amplifiers group actually sent over a link to some backstory mm-hmm. about the Hammonds that I think is very important, because so far we've kind of been speculating about some things.
Are we talking about the backstory on the Burns that led to their arrest, that led to the,
that actually
to prison?
Led backstory going back to the 1960s.
Let's go with that here in a moment. Let's finish the interview first. There's maybe about another minute here to go. So stand by on the backstory.
What specifically, though? Because I'm not getting a specific answer. What does the government have to say, or a government official have to say, that you'll find appropriate and say that this occupation will end?
Well, it has ended because we've basically removed them at this point from the management, which they do not have authority to be doing in the first place. We are extremely
I'm sorry. You haven't removed them from the management. You've just taken over an empty building on the weekend because the feds weren't there at the time. They are still very, very in the belief that they manage that particular piece of property.
Yes.
And they are going to at some point likely assert their believed control over that property. It sounds a little delusional.
Extremely saddened by what has happened to Dwight and Stephen. Innocent people that have Stephen Hammond, innocent people that have been that are symptoms of a much greater problem. But and we're saddened that they're being forced to go to prison for the second time for the same crimes, up to 5 years for 5 years.
How many
in
people?
Prison. But again, this is just a. It's a symptom of a greater problem, which is the federal government controlling the land and resources that belong to the people.
All right. So there is the interview with CNN and the CNN anchor trying to get a straight answer out of him. And I can understand the frustration of the anchor, but I can also understand where, you know, Eamon can't really answer the question. You know, the anchor wants to know, what specifically do you want the government to say or do here? And it's not like, you know, some federal agent could, you know, get behind a microphone and announce, all right, well, we've given in. Mr. Ammon and fellow protesters, we have had a meeting and have decided that we are going to withdraw from this land and shut down the Bureau of Land Management. We're going to end this conflict by ending our control over your lives. We, the federal government, are calling it a day. Good day, everyone. We're going home. As though that is going to ever happen, number one. And number two, even if it did, that they would be telling the truth? No, of course not. So you can't trust, you know, if the government came out and said, all right, this is it. We're going to be abiding by the Constitution from here on out. Finally, these 150 armed protesters have gotten it through our heads that we have been wrong for hundreds of years. We have been unconstitutionally ruling over your lives. We, the federal government, are going to change our ways. I mean, this is like an abuser saying to his abused wife that he's going to be good in the future.
I'll stop beating you.
Yeah, just, you know, come out from hiding, lady. I'll stop beating you.
And abusers generally say something along those lines.
And maybe they'll stop for another day, but then things will get worse over time. So there's really no answer he can give because there's no realistic way that the federal government is going to do what he wants them to do. Whatever sort of nebulous idea he has for this country needs to change. Well, it ain't going to happen because of this. And, you know, it'd be great if it did, but come on, let's get realistic here. So we're going to get into the background of the Hammonds here in a moment. Those are the two guys who are going to prison tomorrow, going back to prison for lighting some fires. You've got some history on that. Plus, there's video. We're trying to ascertain, to boil down this 14-minute long video from a man named Blaine Cooper, who is basically apologizing to his family, sounding like he's going on a suicide mission here. You've got people who are involved in this conflict, who are involved in this takeover, who appear to be prepared to die, which suggests that if the government gets violent, that this is not going to go very well. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got time for you. If you want to share your thoughts, what direction do you expect to see this go? Do you have more information? You know, is there details that have come out here since we've started talking about it tonight on the show that that we need to know about that we haven't really come across yet? You know, what are we missing from this discussion? Feel free to fill in any gaps. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype at Skype username lrn.fm, and this is Free Talk Live.
As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock's CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
Are your kids spending too much time online? Are they gaming instead of doing homework? Are they on Facebook instead of sleeping? Turn their internet access on or off when you want for free at webcurfew.com. 100% web-based interface means nothing to download, install, or configure. Webcurfew is free and controls any device using your home network without slowing down your internet. Block all adult web content with the click of a button. Don't let the internet raise your kids. Take back control of how and when your home internet is used for free. Visit webcurfew.com.
You can control your health care with Liberty HealthShare.
Liberty HealthShare is like-minded people coming together to share medical costs, which saves money.
You don't even have to pay for procedures that violate your conscience.
Because we all share the same values.
Join the movement of people who share in medical costs and change the way you pay for your health care forever.
Go to libertyhealthshare.org to find out more.
Liberty HealthShare.
Together, we're changing health care for good. libertyhealthshare.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, January 3rd, 2016. Silver is trading at $13.87 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,061 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $433. Antiwar.com reports months of bloody infighting over the leadership of the Taliban movement has reportedly ended, with a deputy from the splinter faction headed by Mullah Rasool announcing that the talks had ended in a ceasefire and an agreement to exchange prisoners. Questions remain, however, as the splinter delegation was only able to meet with Habatullah Akhtun, a deputy of leader Mullah Mansour, and was told Mansour is refusing to meet with anyone over security issues. On December 2nd, Mullah Mansour was reportedly seriously wounded in a gunfight among Taliban commanders in Quetta, Pakistan. The Taliban denied that he was wounded in the incident, calling it propaganda, but he has not been seen in public since. This is only adding to the speculation that he's in bad shape, with the concerns about the Taliban not being forthcoming about leadership changes underscored by the revelation in mid-2015 of founder Mullah Omar's death, leading to Mansour's election. Omar was revealed to have been dead for years.
Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system and to fully capitalize on that decision in their fundraising efforts. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com.
UPI reports winter storms that ripped through the central and southern United States at the end of 2015 dealt a blow to the dairy industry in Texas. The Texas Association of Dairymen said in a statement on Saturday that winter storm conditions killed about 5% of mature dairy cows in the state. The group does not yet know how many heifers and calves have been lost. Executive Director Darren Turley said as farmers continue to assess the damage, the number of losses is expected to rise. Turley said in the statement, "The immediate challenge is how to handle these sudden, massive losses of animals. The ordinary methods for disposal cannot handle the volume of deaths we are seeing from this storm." Turley also said blizzard conditions prevented employees from accessing the farms to milk cows, which typically needs to happen twice a day. Turley said when a dairy cow goes that long without being milked, her milk supply starts to dry up. That means the dairy cows in this region will give less milk for months to come. Less milk going to market will be felt by consumers as well as by dairy farmers. Hundreds of loads of milk waiting to be processed went to waste during the blizzard. CNN reported storm system Goliath barreled through Missouri, Texas, Oklahoma, and Georgia earlier this week, causing at least 49 deaths. The upper Midwest and Northeast were also hit with several inches of snow and freezing rain.
For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports Missouri Governor Jay Nixon on Saturday toured communities in his state ravaged by flooding that killed at least 31 people in several states and forced the evacuation of thousands in the Mississippi and Ohio River regions as the danger of rising waters shifted to Arkansas and beyond. Nixon visited Eureka and Cape Girardeau in eastern Missouri, where floodwaters caused widespread damage, and announced that he was requesting the federal government declare an emergency to help with the massive cleanup and recovery now underway. The National Weather Service reported Mississippi floodwaters in Illinois and Missouri began cresting and receding on Saturday after thousands of people had to be evacuated from their homes earlier in the week when the floods destroyed hundreds of structures. 12 counties have been declared disaster areas in Illinois, where Governor Bruce Rauner on Saturday toured several communities hard hit by flooding. On Friday, he ordered Illinois National Guard troops into flooded areas to mitigate damage and help with evacuation. The floods claimed the lives of at least 31 people in Illinois, Missouri, Oklahoma, and Arkansas, many of whom drove into flooded areas after days of downpour. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Do you sometimes feel that healthy eating can be a lot of work with very little reward? Well, no need to worry any longer. Here are the Onion's tips for healthy eating. First, identify your weaknesses, and then condition yourself to avoid problem foods by associating them with deceased relatives, unrequited loves, and traumatic events. Remember, alcohol is a source of empty calories, so be sure to keep your drinking under control. Unless you're really f***ing stressed out, like if something shitty happens at work, or if your cat gets hit by a car. If you find yourself suddenly craving a fatty food, let yourself enjoy the best of both worlds. Tape a slice of ham to your tongue and slowly absorb the taste throughout the day without swallowing. Stay motivated by paying yourself $1 every day until you meet your weight loss goals. At the end of 10 years' time, spend that cash on a cosmetic operation of your choice. There, now you're ready to begin your new healthy lifestyle.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, launching into the third hour here of the live Sunday edition of the program. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Daryl.
And don't forget, you can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features that you'll find there on our site. They are completely free. You get to control the content right there on the front page at freetalklive.com. We're talking about the developing situation in Oregon, the Malheur Federal Wildlife Reserve, which is something like 187,000 acres. There's some kind of a welcome center there, some government building of some sort that protesters have taken over. Armed protesters have taken over. They ostensibly broke into the property at some point earlier this weekend after a larger protest to protest the imprisonment or the inevitable imprisonment on Monday of a couple of guys. Hammond is their last name.
Steve and Dwight.
Steve and Dwight. One is an older guy. He's in his 70s. Another in his 40s. And they're going back to prison after the federal government had already sent them there for ostensibly lighting fires on their lands, which spread allegedly to federal properties. And that's why they went to prison in the sometime in the aughts, the last decade. They were released after spending whatever their sentence was, and now a federal judge has come back and said, you need to go back to prison. We missentenced you. We should have sentenced you to more time in prison. So now you've got another 4 years to go rot in a prison cell because of a fire, You set. Now, Daryl, you've got more information about the background on the Hammonds, because so far we haven't really talked very much about them and their story. It's the most of the coverage on the show tonight has been about the takeover, the armed, what will likely become a standoff. I don't know how many federal agents are on the scene yet, but there are a number of people, as few as 15, as many as 150, who are occupying this federal building. And there's apparently a guard tower outside that they are occupying as well. From the pictures we've seen from the media, the property is relatively open. There's not really any forested land, so it's wide open, easy to see from a spotting distance. Someone with a sniper rifle, like a federal agent, for instance, would easily be able to draw a line on these protesters. And they're inviting more people to come there. So basically, there's an open invitation for undercover federal agents to come into their group. And you've got people within the group who are basically armed up, and they are ready to die based on some of the statements that they have made, that if the federal government uses violence, that these people will use violence in return. You've got a video from a Marine who's going out there saying that he's planning to, he's saying goodbye to his family, basically. So it sounds like he's prepared to put his life on the line for this project, for this protest. This demand of a return to the Constitution is what Ammon Bundy, who's the son of Cliven Bundy, that listeners may recall the Bundy Ranch situation from 2014. So one of the Bundys, a couple of the Bundy brothers, are involved in this. So let's go back here, Daryl. Where's the story coming from, and what do you want to share from it?
So the story is coming from a website called the Conservative Treehouse. And they cite their sources throughout their post here. Back in 1908, President Theodore Roosevelt created the what's now the Malheur National Wildlife Refuge out of the Malheur Mud and Harney Lakes. In 1964, the Hammonds purchased a 6,000-acre piece of property in the Harney Basin near the Wildlife Refuge. They also received 4 grazing rights on public land and 3 water rights in addition to the house on the property. In the 1970s, the Fish and Wildlife Service decided to start purchasing up a bunch of land. And one of the pieces...
Eminent domain, you mean? Or just making offers to people?
Not eminent domain.
Okay.
Actual, purchases. Mm-hmm. The expansion wound up surrounding the Hammonds Ranch. The Hammonds were then approached many times but refused to sell. Some other ranchers refused to sell as well. Also, during the 70s, ranchers were told that grazing was detrimental to wildlife and must be reduced. Then 32 of 53 permits were revoked, and many ranchers were forced to leave their property. Grazing fees were raised significantly for those who were allowed to remain, and refuge personnel took over the irrigation system, claiming it as their own. They then did some stuff with the water, and that caused some flooding on a lot of the property in what's called the Sylvie's Plain that was near some of these lakes. The ranchers then fought to keep the Fish and Wildlife Service who had been fighting, broke because their land had been destroyed by the flooding, and they begged the Fish and Wildlife Service to purchase their land. By the 1990s, the Hammonds were one of the few ranchers still owning private property adjacent to the refuge. Susie Hammond, in an effort to make sense of what was going on, began compiling facts about the refuge. In a hidden public record, she found a study that was done by the Fish and Wildlife Service in 1975. The study showed that the no-use policies of the Fish and Wildlife Service on the refuge were causing the wildlife to leave the refuge and move on to private property. The study also showed that private property adjacent to the refuge produced 4 times as many ducks and geese as the refuge. It also showed that the migrating birds were 13 times more likely to land on private property rather than the refuge.
Is that because of mismanagement, that they weren't doing a good job sort of keeping this refuge pristine or something like that? I don't understand.
It was because of the no-use policy. I don't know exactly what that means.
Huh.
But there was a direct correlation, apparently, and Fish and Wildlife even found this out, that the animals were more likely to go to the private property near the refuge than onto the actual refuge. She then brought this to the attention of the Fish and Wildlife Service and refuge personnel. Her and her family became the subjects of a long train of abuses and corruption. In 1994, the Bureau of Land Management and Fish and Wildlife Service illegally began building a fence around the Hammond's water source, owning the water rights
to, supposedly.
Yes. Owning the water rights and knowing that their cattle relied on the water source daily, the Hammonds tried to stop the building of the fence. Mm. The BLM and Fish and Wildlife Service called the Harney County Sheriff's Department and had Dwight Hammond, the father, arrested and charged with disturbing and interfering with federal officials or federal contractors, two counts each of felony.
Whoa.
He spent one night in the Deschutes County Jail in Bend, Oregon, and a second night behind bars in Portland before he was hauled before a federal magistrate and released without bail. A hearing on the charge was postponed, and the federal judge never set another date. The Fish and Wildlife Service also began restricting access to upper pieces of the Hammond's private property. In order to get the upper part of the Hammond's ranch, they had to go on a road that went through the Malheur Wildlife Refuge. The Fish and Wildlife Service began barricading the road and threatened the Hammonds if they drove through it. The Hammonds removed the barricades and gates and continued to use their right of access.
So the federal government made an agreement with them in the 60s or 70s that they had access to the federal roads and the water on the federal lands so they could have their cattle
graze. They had
graze,
water rights.
So they could have their cattle graze and drink. And they had and they also had rights to access the roads, right?
Well, the feds barricaded part of the land and created a road so that the Hammonds, in order to go to like the upper portion of their property, had to go onto federal property to get there.
And they also had permission to do that previously, did they not?
Right? Presumably.
And so now the federal government is trying to take all that away and
violate
their agreement.
The feds barricaded and gated off their access, and then they took those down. The Hammonds were then forced to either build and maintain miles of fence or be restricted from the use of their private property, cutting their ranch almost in half. They could not afford to fence the land, and the cattle were removed. In early 2001, and this is the more recent stuff about the burns.
We're going to get into that here. It's been a long time that these folks have been fighting with the federal government just so they can have and enjoy their private property. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number, 855-450-3733. You can join us here. This is Free Talk Live. Share your thoughts.
All right, listen up, because this is the most important thing you're going to hear all day. What if I said you could make money flipping houses without any cash, credit, or manual labor? And what if I said you could do it part-time from the comfort of your home? Sound unflippin' believable? Hi, I'm Preston Ealy, and I'm going to prove it by sending you a free copy of my smash hit-selling book, How to Get Rich in Real Estate. It sells online for $19.95, but I'm giving away 5,000 free copies this week. To get one before they're gone, call 1-800-961-8439. I used to be so broke. I had my electricity shut off 9 times, but I figured out a simple way to make money flipping houses without even breaking a sweat. Now I'm living the good life, and so should you. Listen, if you're sick and tired of stressing about money, this book could change your life. Hands down, it's the fastest, easiest way to get started in real estate. Let me prove it. Call right now to find out how to get your free book. When they're gone, they're gone. Call 1-800-961-8439. 1-800-961-8439.
Are you worried about your mom or dad living alone in their house? Hi, I'm Joan London. Listen, I know how difficult it is to find senior care for someone you love. That's why I recommend a free service called A Place for Mom. They are the nation's largest senior living referral service. Call A Place for Mom today.
To receive free information on senior living communities in your area, call A Place for Mom at 1-800-704-6182.
A Place for Mom offers free one-on-one advice from local advisors and a personalized list of senior living communities you can visit. If you have questions about senior care for your mom or dad, there's a place for answers, A Place for Mom.
Call A Place for Mom in the next 10 minutes to get your free ebook on financing senior care as well as free information on senior living communities in your area. Call 1-800-704-6182. That's 1-800-704-6182.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 90% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com.
LRN.FM is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.FM in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate us 5 stars, then share the link on your social media and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.FM. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading on Thursday, gold is $1 lower at $1,063 per ounce. Silver is even at $13.93 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $423. Our offices are closed this week for year-end processes and to enjoy the holidays with family and friends, but you can still shop our online store at rrbi.co for some of the best deals you'll find on silver and gold. rrbi.co.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733 with you in the studio tonight. It's Ian.
And Daryl.
Don't forget, you can join us online anytime at freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features there. And you can submit content right there to the front page by using our Reddit-based system, which is totally free to do. Find something interesting that you want to share with us and with our other listeners, then just submit it there over at freetalklive.com. You can vote on other people's submissions as well. It's all free. freetalklive.com. We're talking about the Hammonds, the two guys who are going to be turning themselves into prison on Monday, going in for another sentence. So there's no double jeopardy in the United States in that you can't be charged twice for the same crime, but apparently you can be sentenced twice for the same crime. These men allegedly set fires on their ranch land outside of the Malheur National Federal Wildlife Reserve, which ostensibly caught onto the reserve. They then were charged with crimes of, I forget what the charges were exactly, but they were charged with something over that, sentenced to a few months or up to a year in prison. They spent that time in the last decade. Then, when they were released, a judge later came back and said, you've got to go back to prison. I should have sentenced you for a longer period.
Or it's actually a different judge.
Then we should have sentenced you for a longer time, and they're sending them back.
The court made an error.
Yeah, so apparently double jeopardy doesn't apply when the court makes an error and decides to send you back to prison after you thought you had served the full amount of time that you were supposed to serve. Now there are protesters who are armed and have broken in allegedly to an unoccupied building over the weekend on the Malheur Reserve. They are allegedly armed. There are as many as 150 of them, maybe as few as 15. We really don't know how many, and they are not revealing those numbers. The protesters are saying they're dug in. They're saying they have enough supplies to last for years and are basically demanding the federal government return to constitutional principles. Now, you know, they're not going to get that demand, so ultimately it's likely going to come to some sort of a showdown with federal government agents who I'm sure are either on the scene now or en route
to set up some sort of perimeter and cordon off this particular area to bring it to some kind of a showdown. Let's go to your phone calls here. We're going to tell you more about the Hammonds and what precipitated what's happening now. We haven't yet gotten to the story about the Burns. You've given us a little bit in the past history. This family has had a long history of conflict with the federal government. They're just trying to ranch their land.
They're trying to ranch. The feds want to buy the property, and they don't want to sell.
Let's go to Lynette. She is on the line in California. Lynette, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Daryl.
Yeah, thanks for covering this story tonight. You guys are putting out a lot of really good information.
Thanks. What did you want to share?
I guess my problem with a lot of the media coverage is going to be that the protesters out at the Wildlife Center, they're going to be depicted as a bunch of yahoos. And, you know, we've already seen it. We've seen the video with this guy Blaine, who's all decked out in, you know, in his militia gear. But I've seen pictures of the people that are out there, and they're just dressed like regular people.
Is there more video of Blaine? Because the video we have of Blaine is him in his truck. He's not decked out in anything. He's just sitting in his truck. Is there a different video of him somewhere?
Yeah, there's one that looks like it was shot from an iPhone. You can find it out there where he's speaking. You know, he sounds pretty rational. But,
this is the guy who, for our listeners just tuning in, sorry to interrupt, Lynette. This is the guy, we've got a 14-minute long video of him talking into a camera, like a dash cam in his car, where we've only watched a few minutes of it off the air just to see what he says, but he's basically apologizing to his family. It makes it sound like he's ready to lose his life over this. What's the context of the video you've seen with him in it?
Oh, he speaks after Ammon Bundy. Bundy gives a little bit of a talk, a little bit of an interview or a statement out there at the property, out there at the Wildlife Center. And then Blaine comes on wearing, you know, his Marine hat, some paramilitary gear. And he talks about, dealing with the federal government as the bullies they are. And, you know, he doesn't really sound like, he doesn't really sound unreasonable. But because he's in paramilitary gear, he's going to be the guy that's focused on. When really, the people I'm seeing out there, for the most part, are just appropriately dressed for the weather and don't appear to be suicidal. They just want to call attention to this case and what's going on out in the West, particularly with the BLM. The BLM has been harassing farmers all over the West.
That's the Bureau of Land Management. Lynette, it sounds like you've been watching some of the footage from this situation. How many of the people they're showing are actually openly carrying guns?
I've only seen one, just Blaine.
Okay, interesting. You know? Do you think Blaine is legitimate, or is he like a federal plant who's there to gin up violence?
I guess it's possible he could be an agent provocateur or something out there. I don't know. I do think that there are a lot of people who are like him, but for the most part, the people out there appear to be just regular people, not interested in starting trouble.
So you wouldn't describe this as some of the media has as a militia then?
No. There could be people out there calling themselves militia. I don't know because I'm not out there. I haven't talked to the people there. I'm just looking at videos and photographs. And a lot of them just seem to be, people who consider themselves to be patriots, conservatives, maybe people like I was a few years ago.
So you don't feel like, I mean, obviously you don't know these people and not all of them have been interviewed, but so you're just going based on what they look like on video. You don't feel like everyone there is on a suicide run.
No, and certainly the Bundys aren't. Carol Bundy, Ammon Bundy's mother or stepmother, I don't believe she's suicidal. I think she's out there.
Okay. Anything else that you feel you want to share with our audience of your observations, Lynette?
No, just really thanks a lot for covering this story.
Sure. And we'll continue to cover it. Thank you for the call tonight. And hopefully, maybe, what would be really cool is if some Free Talk Live listeners in the area could actually go out and sort of, recon what the situation is like and, give us your perspective. If you live in Oregon or Northern California or something like that, if you can make the trip up there to, observe, not to go into the actual showdown,
unless that's something you feel called to do. But to, you know, go on the outside and at least, you know, get the perspective, get a perspective from this situation that's not being skewed by the mainstream media or the federal government.
Right.
So if you want to share your thoughts here, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Dwight and Steve Hammond to report to prison on Monday for sentence part two, a resentencing of a higher sentence, which in my opinion should not be allowed to happen. Once a judge issues a sentence, the only thing that should be able to happen to that sentence is it is reduced. I don't think that you should be able to come back and sentence someone to a longer period of time.
I do think that they have a good lawsuit on that ground, if they can find a lawyer willing to take the case pro bono.
But this isn't the first time this has happened. There have been other people sentenced for longer
periods. I don't know if anything like this has ever gone to the Supreme Court.
Good question. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. More history of the Hammonds here in a moment. Daryl, you're going to share that with us. What happened around these supposedly controlled burns that allegedly got out of control and led to these charges that are now leading to this protest and the occupation of a federal building in Oregon? The situation continues to develop. It's Free Talk Live.
Piedmont attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey System. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission, the Wage and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service, and the Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare. And, of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation...
It's very hard to get anything done these days if you're in business, but free enterprise built this country. Think what could happen if we don't keep it free. A public service of this station and the Center for the Defense of Free Enterprise, Bellevue, Washington.
Besides, we just can't have people floating about unregulated, you know.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, live Sunday edition here. You may join us on the radio waves. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've been discussing really throughout most of the show tonight the situation in Oregon at the Malheur Federal Wildlife Reserve, which is developing as we speak. There are as many as 150 people occupying the federal building on that property. And, you know, come Monday, there were people supposed to be showing up at work, purportedly, at this building. The Wildlife Reserve has now been officially closed to the public, although the people that are inside this building are inviting members of the public to come and join them in what they say is an occupation that could last for years. They claim they have enough food to last them for years here. And they're doing it in response to the targeting of the Hammond family, which is a family that owns a ranch adjacent to and surrounded by this particular wildlife reserve. The federal government, Bureau of Land Management people have been harassing this family and have been trying to get them to sell their property to
the federal government. Part of 4 decades.
Right. And so now they're sending a couple of the Hammonds back to prison to spend longer in prison after they were already sentenced once for setting a fire on their land, or more than one perhaps, but setting fires.
Right. And that's where the story that I have that's giving the back info or the backstory. That's where we're at in this. So in the early fall of 2001.
And where's this coming from, by the way, this story?
This is the Conservative Treehouse.
Okay, got it.
In the early fall of 2001, Stephen Hammond, the son, called the fire department to inform them that he was going to be performing a routine prescribed burn on their ranch.
Okay.
Later that day, he started a prescribed fire on their private property. The fire went on to public land and burned approximately 127 acres of grass. The Hammonds put the fire out themselves. There was no communication about the burn from the federal government to the Hammonds at the time. Prescribed fires, by the way, are a common method that Native Americans and ranchers have used in the area to increase the health and productivity of the land for centuries.
Fires happen naturally anyway, and they sort of... they perform the same service, if you will, clearing underbrush and
yes.
things like that.
And I'm glad you mentioned natural fires, because in 2006, there was a massive lightning storm that started multiple fires mm-hmm. that then joined together in flaming the countryside. To prevent the fire from destroying their winter range and possibly their home, Stephen Hammond started a backfire on the private property. The backfire was successful in putting out the lightning fires that had covered thousands of acres within a short period of time.
How does I don't know enough about fire. How does a fire put out fire?
Because you know how fires work, right? That yeah. fires can only burn things that haven't been burned.
Right.
So you start a fire and you burn stuff wide enough so that when the fire comes by, there's not anything fresh for it to wind up burning.
Got it. Gotcha. So you
start a fire, then you put that fire out.
Before
the other fire reaches.
Got it.
So that basically you burn out the fire because there's nothing else that it can wind up burning.
They made a fire moat, basically.
Basically, yeah. Yes. Okay. They made a fire moat.
Yep.
The backfire saved much of the range and vegetation needed to feed the cattle through the winter. The next day, federal agents went to the Harney County Sheriff's Office and filed a police report making accusations against Dwight and Stephen Hammond for starting the backfire. A few days after the backfire, a range con, which I don't know what that is, A range con from the Burns District BLM office asked Stephen if he would meet him in town for coffee.
Uh-oh.
Stephen accepted. When leaving, he was arrested by the Harney County Sheriff, Dave Glarup, and BLM Ranger Orr. Sheriff Glarup then ordered him to go to the ranch and bring back his father. Both Dwight and Stephen were booked on multiple Oregon state charges. The Harney County District Attorney reviewed the accusation, evidence, and charges, and determined that the accusations did not warrant prosecution and dropped all charges.
At the county level, but then charges were brought by the feds. We'll get to the rest of the story here. Mike is on the line in Alabama. Mike, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi, Ian. It's good to talk to you.
Hey there.
I need to call you anyway, but not under these kind of conditions anyway.
All right.
We've been getting some updated information during the day about this situation. What's been released so far, and as you know, the media usually looks for the lunatic fringe and interviews them in order to get it to paint the whole crowd with a picture of
sure.
all fruitcakes. Well, in this particular instance, evidently these guys do not plan on doing anything to destroy the facility, and the feds have said as long as they don't intend to interfere, as long as there's no violence or destruction of property.
I find that hard to believe.
Also, well, that's the information that I'm getting.
I'm just going to clarify. I'm not saying it's hard to believe they won't destroy the facility. I think they're not going to destroy the facility. I don't believe the feds that they're just going to stand back and let them sit there.
I believe that the feds at this point are saying we don't intend to
and they can
the
change
blank.
Their intention later.
Intentions can
I
always
see where
change.
You're going.
Yeah.
Yeah, I see where you're going. They can always change and then charge the facility. But right now, I think they're looking more at damage control than anything else.
All right.
But to go further, these guys have said they were going to hold out for a couple of days, and then they're going to turn themselves in. And I think what they're doing is giving themselves enough time for an ACLU lawyer to come forward and say, okay, I'm going to handle your case because you've obviously been done wrong. When you were speaking about double jeopardy a little while ago.
And what are they going to turn themselves in for? Breaking and entering?
No, the Hammonds.
No. Oh, the Hammonds. I'm sorry. I missed
Steve and Dwight.
Okay, yeah.
Right. To satisfy the warrant for their arrest to be re-imprisoned.
Yeah, I don't know if it's a warrant. Yeah. I think they have a date that they're scheduled to turn themselves in at prison. Normally when you go to jail, you get an order of internment, and it specifies that you have to report to a certain facility by a certain time and date. So there's likely not really a warrant for their arrest, and it's not the same thing as turning yourself in. But yeah, they're expected to report
right.
to prison tomorrow.
Yeah, now that's what they say. They're going to do this tomorrow or the following day. But they were doing this to stir up attention around the country to their cause. And I think it was to draw out the ACLU, which should be the love to get right on top of this to defend these guys.
Yeah, I don't know if the ACLU would take this case on. I don't know about that. I mean, I like a lot of the work that they do. They're a very, you know, pro-freedom, pro-constitutional group in a lot of ways. I just don't know if they're going to be able to, you know, defend. I'm sorry, are you saying the ACLU would take the Hammonds case or the case of the protesters?
The Hammonds.
Okay.
And the protesters are another matter.
Yeah.
Now, it depends on what they do. Now, right now, they're trespassing on federal property is basically the way the feds are looking at it. But they're trying to enter into some damage control. Because if they act in too aggressive a manner, it's going to make them look bad. So they don't want to do that unless there's some real reason to do it.
I agree. They don't want this to be another Waco, likely, which is one of the reasons they didn't use shots fired to take the Browns or the Ed and Elaine Brown when they were occupying their own home. The feds wanted to steal that from them here in New Hampshire. They were able to arrest them without anybody getting shot. I expect they're going to try to bring undercovers in and then make a move on folks. But if there's somebody in there who's suicidal and wants a shootout with the feds, they might get what they're looking for.
That's the problem there. Now, this kind of thing usually draws a certain amount of people who have a couple of bolts loose and needed to have them tightened up.
Sure does.
And that's what's, you know, that's the danger here.
Yeah, that's why this
is
a scary situation for everybody that's in this protest who is peaceful and who do not intend to get into a firefight. There are going to be some nutters who are in there, absolutely, who are looking to go down in flames. And if there are innocent people standing nearby, they may get caught in the crossfire. And that's probably one of the scariest parts here.
Well,
Go ahead.
If you remember, not long ago, when the cattlemen had the problem out there, when the government was trying to take that thing, was take their cattle or something. They had a bunch of armed militia, so-called militia guys, show up, and the feds kind of surrounded it and kind of tried to contain it until it went away.
And Cliven and Bundy at that time did say that he didn't support violence as the solution. Mike, thanks for calling in from WFPA here tonight. I appreciate it there in Fort Payne. This is Free Talk Live. More coming up. Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof form of money to the people, where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom and the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Did you know that home break-ins increase more than 100% during the holidays? It takes just 10 seconds for an intruder to kick in your door. But police response to a home alarm system is more than 20 minutes. And intruders are in and out of your home in 5 minutes. Thieves know that you're not home and have presents inside just waiting to be taken. And if you are home, how safe will you feel with an intruder lurking inside with your family? That's why police across the country are recommending you use Door Armor. Proven to withstand the force of a battering ram, Door Armor keeps intruders out. It's easy to install and barely visible, and your Door Armor is guaranteed for life. Go to invasionstopper.com for a very special buy one, get one at half off deal. These savings are for a limited time and only available to GCN listeners. Protect your valuables and loved ones this holiday season. Go to invasionstopper.com now. That's invasionstopper.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
It's Free Talk Live. Moments remain, enough time for you. If you dial now, you can join us at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. If you care about freedom and you really want to do something about it that's, let's say, not as drastic as taking over a federal building, the Free State Project is the way to go. Go to nhlibertyforum.com and sign up to join us at the upcoming Liberty Forum. It's happening February 18th through the 21st. We're going to have hundreds of liberty-minded people gathering together at the Radisson Hotel in Manchester to hear from Edward Snowden, who's going to be the keynote speaker, and plenty of other great speakers and panels and things like that, but to really feel what it's like to be around hundreds of people who care about the ideas of liberty, because that's what it's like living in New Hampshire. You are literally around more libertarians and voluntarists than you could possibly know at this point in the Free State Project, which we're still in the early mover phase of this project. The Free State Project, of course, is the idea of gathering 20,000 like-minded people who care about freedom and liberty, many of whom believe the federal government is way out of bounds as well, like a lot of the people in Oregon. And, you know, coming here to work within the system, work outside of the system, do whatever it is that you feel is right, that's peaceful in order to achieve liberty in our lifetime. So go to nhlibertyforum.com and join us February 18th through the 21st. We are going to be broadcasting live throughout the entire event. It's an awesome event. It's the 9th Liberty Forum. And once again, Edward Snowden, one of the keynote speakers, nhlibertyforum.com. And if you've yet to sign up for the Free State Project, please go now and do that. You don't need to die in a firefight with the federal government to make a stand for liberty. You can stand peacefully with other people here in New Hampshire. FreeStateProject.org, it's now reached over, I believe, 18,500. Earlier today, it was like 18,499 participants. So we're gathering new signers every day, literally dozens of new signers. We're going to complete that 20,000 probably within the next several weeks. It's a very exciting time for the Free State Project. And if you care about liberty, you really need to start making plans to come here and join us. FreeStateProject.org. We're going to go to your calls. But first, Daryl, you had a few more things you wanted to share on the Hammonds, the guys who are going to prison tomorrow in to serve an additional sentence after they'd already served some time for some alleged fires that they lit on their property in Oregon.
Right. So in 2006, there was a lightning fire. The Hammond son, Stephen, set a backfire on his private property that wound up stopping the spread of the lightning fire. The local authorities came up with some state charges, went to a county court. County judge threw the charges out, said, this is preposterous, threw them out. 5 years later, in 2011, the police, or 5 years after the police report was taken, a U.S. attorney's office accused Dwight and Stephen of completely different charges and accused them being of being terrorists under the Federal Anti-Terrorism Effective Death Penalty Act of 1996.
What?
The act carries a minimum sentence of 5 years in prison, maximum sentence of death.
What?
Yes, they charged them with terrorism because of the fires.
Who was being terrorized? The cows?
I don't know.
Okay.
But
I didn't even realize that was what they were charged with. I didn't get that
detail. They were charged with violating the Federal Anti-Terrorism Effective Death Penalty Act of 1996. They were labeled arsonist. And there's more to this. We've got the link on the Facebook page.
So did they plead guilty or something? Like, why did they end up getting convicted of terrorism?
Because they went to court.
Because it's
and
federal
the
court.
Judge found them guilty.
Because federal court pretty much always finds you guilty.
Yes.
All right. We're going to go to the phones here. And I'd just like to remind people, Free Talk Live is live from 7 to 10 at night Eastern Time, 7 nights a week. If you want to call the show, you're welcome to call at any time. But the worst time to call is at the very end of the show because, well, first of all, it's the end of the show. But secondly, for whatever reason, people love to call in the very last segment of this program. We've had open phones throughout the show here tonight, and now we have almost a full board of calls that literally all just came in within the last 5 minutes.
So now we have to rush through everybody's call.
Right, exactly. So if you really want to have a chance to speak on the air and you know, get your thoughts out, this is the worst time to call in. That said, let's go to your calls and thoughts. We got Scott listening in South Carolina, Charleston's WTMA. Hello, Scott.
Hello. This is starting to remind me a little bit of Wounded Knee, you know, with the occupation of federal land. I was calling about my outrage over them being charged with a terror crime. To be honest with you, until a moment ago, I thought it was one of the new ones since 9/11. I didn't realize it was from 1996. I still think it's absolutely outrageous. And I guess the third thing is, when does nobody ever gets the max sentence on anything? And these guys are getting the max sentence, aren't they?
Oh, no, they're getting the minimum.
Some people do get the max sentence. But
I thought 5 years was the max.
No, five years is the mandatory minimum. The death penalty is the maximum.
Oh, okay. Well, then I misunderstood that. Thank you for clarifying
that. No problem.
But I still think the whole thing's outrageous.
Scott, anything else you want to share? Thanks.
No, that's great. Thanks
for the call, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Let's go to a different Scott. This one's in Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Scott.
Hey, man. How you doing?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
Okay. So I just wanted to talk, like, I heard about all that Oregon stuff that was going down.
Yeah.
And I was just really concerned that I heard no reporting outside of local media about what happened in my town today.
All right. What happened in your town?
All right, so there's this man, like, you may have heard of him if you're up on your internet, you know, charisma, all that kind of stuff. But his name is Brian Silva. And what he does is he gets on the internet and posts video of himself pretending he has firearms, pretending he has a lot of currency that he doesn't actually have, saying, gra-ta-ta-ta-ta. And, like today, the cops went outside his house. It was the SWAT team, the local drug enforcement team, and two police departments from surrounding counties there surrounding his house. And he was firing shots. They were firing shots. And
whoa.
It's just like, it's ridiculous, man. Everything is going crazy in this country. And I just wanted to hear your opinion on it, for real.
Well, thank you. I did just pull up the story here from Charlottesville where police confirmed that 25-year-old Brian Silva has been arrested after a standoff. He has been charged with abduction and possession of a firearm by a convicted felon. So apparently, if you are a convicted felon, it is a bad idea to go on YouTube and make videos with yourself possessing a firearm. That might not be a good plan.
Man, I've been watching them videos for months now. I've been seeing him posting stuff with him with a goddamn Glock. And he's sitting there, and he's like pointing it wherever. He got a wad of money in his other hand. He's acting like he's some real stuff.
Well, you know, while I think that felons should be free to carry firearms, I think that stupid people are going to end up in prison for doing things like this. Thanks for the call tonight, Scott. I appreciate it. That's a great accent, too, by the way. I don't know if it's real.
I don't know.
Maine. Let's continue.
Listen, Maine.
Maine. Let's go to Robert. He's in Louisiana. Hey, Maine. What's up?
How y'all doing?
Hey.
Good. Hey, I was reading about that story, you know, the Oregon deal today.
Yes, sir.
And I'm going to be honest, I'm kind of worried because I've watched a little video by Alex Jones, and he was talking about this might lead to civil war. I'm kind of worried about that, to be honest.
Alex Jones thinks that everything is going to lead to civil war.
Oh, does he?
Yes.
With whom would the war be between? That. The federal government and protesters?
I have no clue, to be honest. That's how I wanted to call y'all, because y'all would know more than I would. That's why I wanted to ask y'all.
Well, I mean, there's definitely a lot of frustration with the federal government, and this Clive and Bundy, Hammond family situations are examples of the sort of the latent, built-in frustrations that a lot of Americans have with the federal government. If this blows up into something more than what it is right now, I guess time will certainly tell. But Alex Jones, you know, profits from fear-mongering, basically. And I've met Alex in person, and I think he's a nice guy, and we've had him on this show once in the past, or actually he's called in.
Did he accuse you of being Illuminati?
No, he didn't. He was very nice, and we actually went on his show as well, and it was fine. But that's just his bailiwick, Robert. That's what he does, and he gets people whipped up, and it's a good way for people to, you know, if Alex Jones is saying that there's going to be a civil war, it might get people to tune into his show on Monday. Thanks, Robert, for your call here. Let's go to Tom in Michigan quickly. Tom, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Daryl.
Hey, how you doing tonight?
Hey, Tom. Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, I just wanted to talk about the cartels operating out of Dearborn right now, selling meth and meth-like products that aren't actually meth. They're killing people by the hundreds. I'm telling you, it's an epidemic here. And I just basically wanted to bring up the fact that local government here is taking major bribes to look the other way, and nobody's doing a thing about it.
Tom, thanks for the heads up on that. Appreciate hearing from you. And that tends to be how it is with governments. They will be corrupted by drug cartels. I don't know if what he was saying was accurate. We don't live in Dearborn. But certainly if you want to call and explain a little further, tomorrow night we'll be here. And I believe we're going to be having a conversation with Joel Valenzuela, who is an activist here in New Hampshire, about the best way to be an activist. But we'll continue to update you on Oregon.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for LRN.FM are, 1, let your friends know you're listening to LRN.FM on your social networking profile. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.lrn.fm. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program at amp.lrn.fm. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same great prices, and LRN gets a cut. Please do your online shopping at shop.lrn.fm.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.